Celebrations start here in the parish of Menlough. Looking round us, you can see down in front of me the parish church, and in the graveyard some of those people who played in the 19 from there on until 36-38. Some of them rest in there. Over beyond is Mikey Mitchell's house and Paddy Crowell, some of the people who have dug up those records for this big celebration. Now, I'll move over to talk to those people who have gone to length to find out the true, or as true as possible, as they can get to the records for today. Now, Mikey, would you come over here and talk to me about what you have done up until now?
Well, just for the moment, the record on this field is 1896. The first game here was played against Kilkerran. Kilkerran travelled here to Menlough by pony and trap, we are reliably told. And they played Menlough. The Menlough team wore blue and white. And Kilkerran wore lily white. '19 to '16. We haven't exactly got the names of the players, but we are told that it was a very good game. The field was given at that time by John Lowe. Brendan. So from then on, the GAA progressed right down, and today they are still a very strong organisation.
Thank you, Mikey. Paddy Crowell, I know that you didn't play the first match here, Paddy, but you can tell me something about the GAA from when you remember.
Well, I can remember back to 1927, and from that on up to today, of all the happenings. And
you did tell me at one time that you remember playing with my father, is that true?
Yes, back in Caltra at one time. They were one shot and I was underage, as a matter of fact.
You're such a young man, and my father is 88 years of age now. There's a big difference in age. You said you were underage, were you?
Oh, yes, I was only a minor. Well, not even a minor, a juvenile, I suppose, at the time.
A hairy minor.
But they were one shot. I always used to follow the teams at that time, you know. So ever since that, for 50 years.
You're still with them?
I'm still with them for 50 years and have followed them up and have known all the people that did play, and most of them are gone now.
Yes. Well, so we'll see you and we'll talk to you later tomorrow, Paddy. Thank you very much. And Sean Harrison, you played, I just seen a picture of you a few moments ago in 1954.
That's right, Tommy.
With some fine fellas.
Such as Paddy Murray, Paddy Crowell, John Joe Crowell, and many others stayed to come back on that particular day. We never won anything, really. The only one thing that stands out in my mind was that we went into an Airport semi-final in Mount Bellia, and we had one of the greatest footballers, I suppose, in Ireland playing with us. Red Barn and Rare, just a few hundred yards from here, Frank Ivers. We were a pint down going into the, oh, I'd say about 5 minutes to go. Yes. We got a penalty. We were delighted to let Frank take it. And I think, as Michal O'Hara often says, he must drive it about 20 yards wide. They left us beaten, but nevertheless. I was always happy to follow up the GAA. There were some great names that always stood out in my mind, such as your father. I was always delighted to hear him talk about it. Him and the late Pat Collins, the Mangans and Waterloo, the Devanes, my late uncles John Welby, and many, many others. Yeah. The Dolans, whom you will be interviewing, yeah, I suppose, shortly.
Yes, John, thank you very much. Now, speaking of those old people, we were going to take a walk down to Brendan Glenn's establishment, the local publican here in town, and we will talk to some of those survivors of those early years of 1927-30. This picture is of the 1936 county final. And Mikey Mitchell will name them now for you.
Back row. Left to right, Marky Nocton, Peter Kelly, John Paul Carey, Matthew Potter, Vincent Welsh, Bob McElwain, Paddy Murray, Bernard Nocton, Mon McElwain, and Brother Bertrand Nocton. Standing is Tommy or Fahey.
Joe Fahey
of Waterloo. Seated beside him is Sergeant Rowan, Tommy Quirk, Jack Kelly, Johnny Carty, John McElwain, Frank Dolan, Jimmy McGrath, Dick Madden, and seated is Garda Boyle. In the front row, Garda Boyle's son, Sean, Paddy Nocton in front, and Bernie Fahey. And the child on the right is Paddy Nocton's daughter, Tisha.
We are now down at Glenn's establishment here in the village of Menlough, and we are very happy to have seated here in front of Brendan's pub some of the gentlemen who played in the 1936 county final. And it certainly gives me great pleasure to be invited here, and it gives me doubly great pleasure to first of all introduce to you the oldest member here today is my father, Jim Higgins, and he's 88 years of age. So I just want to ask him a few things about that, how far back he can remember playing with the local club.
Yes, Father. Mm-hmm. Paddy Murray said 1916. What was your first game with Menlough?
My first game with Menlough?
In Ballymac.
Who were we playing in that time?
Ballymac.
We're going to remember. I remember Jack Kelly. I remember as well. Playing it.
You remember playing with Menlough that year?
I do.
And did you win?
We did not, because...
Why would I?
I'll tell you the reason why we couldn't win, because Ballymac won the 1915 championship in 1960 for County Galway. Ballymac won both of them match, county finals.
Yes. And then you told me sometime about 1931. Do you remember playing in 1931?
Yes. Who was that in there?
Williamstown.
We didn't win
it,
from Williamstown. Was it in Mount Bellew who was playing?
No. No, it was Kilkevin 3 days before Christmas.
Yes.
1929.
Yes.
They played them again in 1930 in the pitch in Mount Bellew. And they played them again in Kilkevin.
Now, we were talking to Paddy Murray because my father, a year and a half ago, had a stroke and he cannot remember too well. But we'll get back to him later and we'll continue on with Paddy Murray.
Well, we played them in 1929, Williamstown, 3 days before Christmas in Kilkerran, and Mick Halliday, the late Mick Halliday, he refereed the match. And we played them again in 1930 in Mount Bellew pitch. It was a draw of the two eyes. And we played them again in Kilkerran, and it was a draw. And we played them in Tuam in 1930, October, after 1929, the same final. And then we played them in Mount Bellew, which played 31, in the pitch in Mount Bellew. And it was still a draw. And then we played them again in Kilkerran again, and I think it was still a draw. Was it, Frank?
Yes.
So that was four draws?
Four draws.
And it was never finished, was it?
Never finished. Never finished.
And where is the medals from that game?
Oh, we hold the medals for no, there was no medals. We never got no medals.
But you're still looking for the medals, yeah?
No, we are not.
Would you take them if you got them?
We would not.
All right.
Fair. We would not. But we got no medals in 1936 or 37.
That was the first time.
First time we got a county championship medals. We beat Ballinasloe in Kilconnell in November 1937 for this 1936 county championship.
Very good, Paddy. I'll be back.
We beat them a few points. The late Paddy Roach was playing full back that time. The late Paddy Roach, the great...
That's the day you got the kick and dangled from...
That's right, but the late Paddy Roach... Ryan. The late Paddy Roach was playing for Ballinasloe slow in his old days, like, you know, when one of the greatest footballers that ever played for Galway. The late Paddy Roach, Ballinasloe.
Very good, Paddy. We're moving on now to Frank Dolan from Vermont. Thank you, Paddy.
Well, on that day that we did play Ballinasloe, the county final, 1936. I was lucky enough, I scored 8 out of 9 points for them. I got 9 frees and I scored 8 of them.
Jesus, that was great.
And I think the whole credit, or the weight of the credit of that game goes to the man here inside me, Munmack, that played full back.
Munmack,
he saved everything that came into him.
John McElwain, captain.
Certainly a great name around here for a long time with my father, Mun McElwain. Do you remember that day, Mun?
Ah, yes, one of the greatest days of my life, I think. Yeah, one of the greatest days, surely, yeah.
And what position did you play on that day?
Fullback. I was playing fullback. Yeah. I think Paddy Murray made a mistake there and when he said Paddy Rose played fullback.
Full forward.
No, he played full forward.
Full forward.
But he was a very aged man at the time, and it was very easy to handle him. So don't give me a whole lot of credit for that. He was a failing man at the time. Naturally enough, the man that played in 1925, I believe.
1923.
Oh yeah, he was one of the greatest.
Well, I was talking to somebody the other day, and they said that you were the man that had the greatest kick around about here. It was a very wet day, I believe, and. You hit the ball at the 50-yard line, and I believe a fellow by the name of Mick Gately was standing at the back of the goals. And when you kicked the ball, a blast of water came from the ball and knocked Mick Gately out in the back of the goals. Was that true?
Well, somebody told me that afterwards, but I didn't see it.
But that was a fact.
But he survived anyhow.
He survived anyhow.
Okay, Mun.
I think the greatest drive ever I had. We happened to be playing Leitrim in a Connacht Junior final. Of course, junior football that time was extremely rough, especially in the late 30s.
Yeah.
But I was playing on an extremely good football. A fellow by the name of Nipperschen. He played from Leitrim. But he got a few soft points of me all right, you see, because he was a real old stager at the job. And Father O'Gee, he was chairman of the Galway Football Board at the time. And I fouled Shanley, but he got a pint. He was deadly with him. And he came out to me and he said, McElwain, he said, don't be fouling. He vexed me anyway, but the ball was placed on the 21-yard line. And as sure as I'm sitting here, Niffer, a fellow by the name of, I forget his name now, from Ballinasloe, he just tipped it over the bar. I think it was the longest kick of all time that ever I threw.
So that would be how many
years? Oh, it was well over 80 yards.
80 years?
Of course, I was ill by a good breeze.
I got that was a great record. 80 yards kick, Mun McElwain.
Now, Peter Kelly, what's your great memory of the 1936, Peter?
The first game ever I was brought into was the 1936 against Carthorne in Parkmore. I was the youngest member of the team that time, and they brought me in. What way they brought me in, I don't know, but we beat Carthorne that day on the way for the county final. The semi-final was played in Athenry against Ortheriard. Menlough beat Ortheriard that time, and they went on to play Ballinasloe in Kilconnell. In 1937-36 county final.
You don't remember the score that day, do you?
No.
Too far back. All right, Peter, we're moving on now to Tommy Quirk. How are you, Tommy?
Not too bad.
And what is your memory of that 36, great 36 day?
Well, at that time now, there was nearly as much sport in the boardroom as what there was in the field.
Yes.
Because every game that was ever played, there was an objection. Menlough played the first round. They played Montpellier in Caltra and Montpellier objected. They played Caltra in Montpellier and Caltra objected. They played Carton in Locked and Carton objected. They played Ortharod in Athenry and Ortharod objected, and they played Benlasloe in the county final and Benlasloe objected. And I just give you an idea what the objections were like that time. Ortharod objected and got a replay on the ground that the crossbar was 2 inches lower in the centre than what it was in each end. And it went to a vote, and the one was in the vote, and it happened to be that a new rule came in at that particular day. Came into force on that particular day that before you could object to the layout of the field, you had to protest to the referee before the game started. So Minley appealed to the Connor Council, and Father O'Dea, when he knew they had appealed, he summoned a special meeting of the county board and awarded the match to Minley. He heard that I've got it in the county council now. And they objected to Benlasloe then, came on and played the fine, and Benlasloe objected. I think they objected to Bob Nicholson.
Late in that objection. Just 1 hour late when they found out about the two.
Benlasloe objected, definitely objected, and the county when final. They went into the meeting in Galway, they didn't attend the meeting in time, they made out their car got broke down because they hadn't proved anything. So the game was worth in that particular time.
Well, there was more objections on those days than there are today.
There was objections, all the technicalities, you know, there was any room at all for it. I remember one time there was an objection beyond in Calder where the crossbar was a tape. And they spent 2 hours arguing one by the courtroom, was a tape a crossbar, was a tape a bear.
They wouldn't want to have a strong wind, would they? Thank you, Tommy. Now we move on to Jimmy McGrath. Certainly a Mindley man at that time, moved on now since, but is back here again this evening, thank God, with us. Jimmy, how are you?
Well, the first time ever I remember, the 1936 team was playing Carton in Locked. I was only about 16 and a half, I think, at the time.
Gossoon.
I was the youngest anyway. They were undecided whether they put me in or not. They thought I was too young. But anyway, I fitted in all right, and we won the match all right. I can't remember much more about it now, but I know they were very tall.
But that time, did you play? Because I remember before I went away, you were playing in goal.
Right? Yeah, that's right.
Were you playing in goal that time?
I was.
You were
I was.
A pretty good goalie, you were, I remember.
Oh, that's the result. I did.
A great goalie. I heard them all talking about you even since. Great
that's
goalie.
All Jimmy, I can recall.
Thanks very much. We'll be back to you. But this man is waving his hands, John Mannion, who has spent some time in the United States. And I believe that the record will show later on that John's people participated somewhat in giving some financial assistance to the GAA back in the beginning of the season. So, John,
I don't know. You ask your father.
I know that, but I know you don't want to say that.
I don't want to say it, please.
But anyhow, you are very welcome.
Thank you very much.
Talk to you later.
Thank you very much.
Now, getting tangled up here in the tape, where did we miss? Yes, we missed Jack Kelly. How are you, Jack? We move in here now to Jack and ask you to remember on that 1936 team.
I do remember that team fairly well. I know. I know all about them. They were a fairly good team all right. One Mike, John and Bob and all these is dead, not much in them. But Mike, they behaved well to win, especially Frank Dorn with him, Paddy Murray centre field. And Frank Dorn for taking 8 points out of 9 frees to the record.
That was the record, yeah.
Where
did you play yourself, Jack?
I did not play.
Oh, you didn't play that?
No.
But you were a sub, though.
I was a sub for sub.
And a good player after that, I believe. I will talk to you later. Paddy, let me step in here. We'll skip Paddy Neil for a minute because Paddy came at a later age. He carried the boots for them. Paddy Neil. Well, they needed that too. Sonny Nocton from Vermont Waterloo. Sonny, how are you?
Not so bad now at all.
Do you remember that 1936?
I remember a lot of them anyhow. I'm not good for years like that. I know there were some very hard games in it.
We have a photograph of you there that you played in that team, 1936.
I was being it anyhow. I don't like playing.
They'll tell me
I was very small, but for a big man to be beside me, it was another show for him to strike it. To get a point. or a goal, he had a job. Right. But well, other than that, no.
If you did get hit, did you have anybody to compare?
But as there's three men there together. Were the three good men as what was in Menlough by time anyhow. That's Moan, Frank Dole and Paddy Murray. They're three together now. I'd say no at that time now.
Yeah.
Moan and Frank and Paddy Murray, yes.
For a freely. It's if it was Midland, if it was 40 yards out, and if it was 50 yards out, Paddy Murray. He'd have to go back. He could go anywhere.
Very good, Sonny.
So,
back up to you.
I'll rush. Tommy Cook there, myself, just be falling. I'll ride right out of my nest. Sell and Mike, what do you call him, from Castle Lake, Mike Gordon, or whatever you call him, is it?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Mike.
They've go up to two big lads. So, I have a good hearty team, and I have nothing more to say about them.
Very good.
I enjoyed them years,
very
all right.
Glad that
I enjoyed
around.
Them years.
I know you did. Mm-hmm. Now, Patrick Crawford. What do you have to say, Paddy?
Well, I remember that 1946 team. They were a fine set of men, no doubt about it. I didn't come on the scene until 1938.
But you remember every one of them, you do?
Oh, indeed I do, every one of them. It was a pleasure watching them, pleasure following them. They were a fine set of men. Right from the goalie out now, they were a fine set of men, no doubt about it.
Does anything stick out in your memory of that day? It was very important, of any of the players.
There was one, the day they played Ochterard in Athenry. That was a very tough game. There was Denis Sullivan there, he was a county player, and there was a couple more brothers of them there as well. And they were real tough men. But Menlough beat them well. They beat them all over the field. I remember one incident anyway, Moan was playing fullback. And Moan at that time, he was only a young fella. He was only in his early 20s.
Yes.
And they were shouting in from the sideline to stick into that fella. Moan was getting away with every ball, you know, that came in. And they were fighting about, watch the fellow with the bald head. And he only in his 20s, you know what I
Good
mean?
Good Lord, yeah. Great men to watch.
Well, great men to watch.
Right.
So we always, like at that time, we started in 1938 again, and it was always my wish that we'd win another county final. So I was managing the teams then from that on till even today.
Yes.
And we did win a county final in 1969.
69, yes.
Yeah. So
I was home for that myself, by the way.
That's right. So we achieved something. And we went in for two or three other county finals after that, but we didn't win.
Well, the 69 one was a replay, was it? Not against Kilconley in June, wasn't it?
We played Kilconley, and that was 1944.
Oh, yes.
And we went into the county final at that time, and Kilgerald beat us. We played Kilconley in Tuam. They beat us all right, but they had an illegal team. So we got the points.
Oh, you wanted an objection?
We won the county, the North Board, in an objection. And we went on then to play Kilgerald in the final. So Kilgerald beat us in the final. That was as near as that team went again to anything. But after that then, after the 50s, the late 60s then,
yes.
We got the team together again and got the young fellas trained up. And we won the county final in 1969.
Good man, Paddy. I'll be back to you again later on. Just one more second here. We see another gentleman here at the door, Mr. Michael O'Neill.
Yes.
How are you doing, Mike?
Doing fine, Tom.
You're looking well.
Oh, I
you remember that year. Of course, you're a younger man.
Yes.
But you remember 1936 team, do you?
Oh, I do, yeah.
Yeah.
I
you
do,
don't
yeah.
remember anything special about it, Mike, that you could tell us that we'll keep on record?
Well, I remember the day they were playing Ochterard in the semi-final in Athenry.
Yes.
I remember Moan Mac that day, kick out.
Yes.
It was a misty day.
Yes.
And you could hear the ball ringing when he hit it. He was land beyond centre field.
You had a great kick, I believe.
Oh, great kick. He was a great man. And so Frank Dolan, and he from 50 yards.
Point
Frank could give
it. And send it over.
Definitely over.
Send it over.
And Paddy Murray was the 50s. Look out then. I'm telling you, the forwards were moving and them boys would take the freeze.
You'd like to see them playing against the present team today, would you?
Ah, well, no. I'm afraid that
there's be a little too strong.
Too many ball legs, you know.
We'll go back again. We'll talk to you later, Mike. Thank you. And we'll go back again here to Frank. Yeah, okay. Frank, You were telling me a story the other day about in Athenry, was it you were playing that Stephen Jordan put the ball down in a hole?
In Kilconnell, yeah, down, so running up and down. There were all 30 rakes now that was in it at that time, all ridges.
Yeah.
They weren't level, right?
Yeah.
And he dropped the ball into it, and I said, would you mind taking that up out of there, Mr. Jordan? And he gave a look at me, another word that I had the free giving again me. But that's the point I missed.
So it was down in the dike,
you said? It was down the dike, but I got 8 out of 9. But that
on that day?
On that day, but that failed me. It was below the dike. I couldn't get in under it.
Well, that was just one you missed. And again, Paddy, do you remember anything since, do you know?
No.
Nothing else to say? How about you?
No, we played Ochterard and Athenry.
That's right.
Ochterard, we played them in Athenry.
What year was it?
That year.
It was the Westport final.
It was the Northport final, the Western. We were playing the Westport win. We played the West. After we beat Ochterard.
Johnny Cathy was full forward. Johnny Cathy was full forward.
Peter Sullivan was playing that day, Ochterard. Great Gaelic footballer.
Who was full forward there?
Huh?
Who did you say was full forward?
Johnny Cathy.
Bernamona.
Yeah.
Johnny's dead now.
A lot of people. Where are the fellas, can you remember, that were playing that are dead now? Can you...
There was John McElwain and Mun McElwain, Johnny Carty.
No, not Mun McElwain. Mun is here.
Excuse me.
He's there.
John McElwain and Bob McElwain.
Bob McElwain,
Dr. McElwain now.
Yes.
Call him, and Johnny Carty and Vincent Welsh now, she did.
I believe somebody told me he was.
Vincent Welsh.
There's some fine people that we miss here today.
Bob Nicholson.
Bob Nicholson. She did.
He is a lead, yeah. Yes, yeah.
You're looking at pictures there, Tommy. Is that what year is this?
I know that one is 30 years, anyhow.
Can you name out any of those?
Is that that's Frank Dolan, Sonny Lahan, Tommy Ward, Matty Potter. I suppose you know who that fellow is.
It's yourself, Tommy Quirk.
Dick Madden, yeah. Johnny McMahon. Peter Kelly, Sonny Norton. I don't know who that is now. Who is that, Peter? Huh? That's Pat Clark, now that's out in the States. He played with that team when he was off from America.
That's your brother, Pat?
Yeah. This Matty Potter, I think.
Mm. Somebody mentioned Tom O'Hara. What's the name of O'Hara there?
There's one of the O'Hara's playing in
Is that Tom O'Hara?
Probably would be now. That would probably be it.
And what year is that?
This one's 38. What
That's 54, I believe. I seen it.
54, team.
Maybe 54. Yeah.
Can you name those... sorry, Tony. Can you name those 54 that you made there?
I wouldn't be able to know. No Murray, anyway. No.
Paddy Murray.
Yeah.
Jimmy McGrath. Peter Kelly. Vincent Ryan. Sean Kelly. Myself. Paddy Madden. Paddy Ryan. Tommy Dibley. Paddy Crawhall. Tommy Collins, Tom Potter, John Joe Crawhall, Tom Bellia, Tom O'Loughlin, Jack Collins, and Frank Dolan.
Very good. And there's some of those people deceased today, isn't there?
That's right.
Some of those.
Tommy Dibley has passed away. Tommy Bellia, Tom O'Loughlin. We still have the rest of them with us.
Thank God. That's about it.
Yeah.
So, you're on. This is the team that Sean Harrison is after naming, the 1954 Menlough team.
Paddy Murray, Jimmy McGrath, Peter Kelly, Vincent Ryan, Sean Kelly, myself, Paddy Madden, Paddy Ryan, the late Tommy Dibley, Paddy Crawhall, Tommy Collins, Bob Tom Potter, John Joe Crawhall, Tom Bellia, Tom O'Loughlin, the late Tom O'Loughlin, Jack Collins, Frank Dolan.
Tell you this, what I never had anyone given out today was how did Menlough get the first football? How did they earn it? How did they earn the first football? Listen to this now, John Mayer.
I wasn't the first football they had, Jim.
Oh, yes, it was.
I would have. I often heard that you had the pig's bladder for a long time.
Well, we had. We had Frank Doolan and his brother, Paddy, took the turf from Pat Mannion and Fairhead and a lot of them, so it was £3 tin. And the way they were to cut the turf was, £3 tin, come on again, do you know? That was the way they were cutting it. Above in Celtic Green Bog.
The bar of football.
The bar of the football. And they gave the money to, Frank Doran and Paddy. Paddy won the bowler. Gave the money to Paddy Doran and Paddy to buy the football. And there's a two pairs of shoes he bought.
Three pairs, you might get a pair of football boots
longer. No, listen to me, this Frank Doran that only knows about it. But he didn't know what he thought about it.
Was that true, Frank?
That was real true, no.
He took the turf, early. Paddy took the turf. And all the footballers gathered and they cut it in 2 evenings. And we got the team registered. And went to Mount Bellew and we got 3 pairs of shoes out of it. And on the 3 pairs of shoes we got in the team register, there wasn't a whole lot left, but I don't know. I got a few pairs of socks and things, but the Genzies didn't come when we had a round of football played. There was no money for them.
Did you play with the long pants that time, or did you
talk about? Oh, we were talked about, all right.
Why wouldn't they, sure, Jim?
First game ever I played, your father said to me, will you mark your man, he said. I said, I can't mark them, they're all the same.
we were below to them in October.
They're all in New Genzies and they're all the same. How can I mark them, they? And they're all the same.
We were below to them in October 19.
I was only 14, though.
And this Williamstown that got knocked out, and Stephen Jordan had him between his two legs, and he gave him a more up, trying to get the wind on him. And some lad was digging Jim, do you see, and he couldn't come near him, but the lad came down anyway, and he stood one side of Stephen Jordan, and the lad, he was rubbing, do you see, giving him a rub up, and he rose up his shoe and he says, look at that, he says, lad, you'll get that if you do that to me again. And and he had 3 Blakey's boot protectors above the top of the shoe, and Stephen Jordan let the fella down and started, lad, busted it out laughing. It's about thrishes. Do you remember that, Jim?
Oh, yeah.
You weren't that bad, were you?
No.
he couldn't get the lad, you see, and he came along and he said, look at that, you'll get that.
He was beyond in Caltera when Bob Gilmer came out of college, the fellow at the shop in Galway now. And he was playing to me and I was not able to play him. I'd manage him on the ground all right, but he was too big. And he used to catch the ball and show it to me. And Jim came down and he tipped me in the back and he said, change it me, lad. That's the brass saw, he's of the Montbello team, but he won't belong. So Bob went up and he got the ball, and your man let him catch it, and when he went to show him the ball, sure, he got the damnedest rattle he ever got. Go back now, and you'll be the best man in my little night, he said. So I was, to his easy play, Bob Gilmer after him. Back now, he said, you'll be the... So Bob was, would find knocked out, and there were, they were saying that black so-and-so, me, they had left him. Oh, Christ, no, didn't that lad at all. He said, but there's a black lad and I'm going up there.
That was the painkillers in those days, was it?
It was the painkillers in them days. And that was a sure one.
So they had no football shoes at nothing. I would.
Murray.
Sunder boots.
Murray, I often seen you running down the football field. You used to play in the midfield. I often seen you running down. And I haven't seen lads sticking again, you know. They fell right rotten knees.
I don't know about that.
You never took a bit of notice.
I know the Sunday boots they used to have on them, and they used to have these Blakey boot protectors. You'd get the whole slate of them in a cardboard.
Yes.
And there was 2 round ones for the round, and then there was every diamond one for the middle. You like what you see in Arch over the chimney. Drive them, there was a round and 2 of them. And then there was a 3-corner one. You put the 3-corner one in the middle. You had the shoe, you'd never wear the front. You'd never wear the front of the shoe then, you know. You'd never wear the sole of the shoe with them on.
Well, you wouldn't wear it walking, but you'd wear it playing, would you?
Oh, well, of course, when you'd be a fine player, you'd get like a new shin. You'd see the protector shining man alive if the sun was out.
You'd see the tracker in some shins, you would, you?
Well, you wouldn't. I suppose you wouldn't, but that's the way they were.
Not in Murray's shoes.
I had no shoes. They had
Murray
no shoes.
Never wore the shoe in any of them.
They never had no shoes. A lot of them for a long time. It was bad. It was bad the way around 1929.
Things were bad.
Yeah. Things were bad. You wouldn't. Money was scarce. You get no money. Only for the odd dance they had, sure they had nothing.
Oh, and then from the year.
No, not at all.
I remember the goodest match of the day. I played. Towards harvest time, and I had three rows of oats to cut, and the measurement is there today for anyone to see it. And I asked Paddy Dolan, John Nofton, and Mickey and Lutner to come with me after the first mass. And they came with me after the first mass. And we cut the three rows of oats. The measurement is there for anyone to measure it. And we cut the three rows of oats, we cut it, found it, and stuck it. And I went down across the fields, me doing the life of my mother, she had me doing the ready, and the lads. And we went in and we ate our dinner. And I jumped up from the table and said, I'll be going. Where's his Paddy Dolan? You'll carry me to Kelter. All right, said I, Paddy. I carried them to Kelter. And when I went back to Kelter, when I went up to the gate, who was there but Marty and Nocton and Paul LeBron? And the 42 of us, the deeper office, Gansy, over his head and gave it to me. So I took off my jacket and gave it to me. But I had a waistcoat on me. So because the next thing was, the ball was thrown up and I had to go. And lay my jacket there to behind some of the middle of the gate. And the next thing was, what happened was, Cody Bryan from Kettle French, his kick was never bitten Croke Park yet. To this day, scoring a point from play 75 years. It's not played, it's not best yet. So, I went out in the field, and who the hell was I playing about Cody Bryan? And Cody Bryan was made for this ball to catch. And Cody Bryan, he had very long legs. And he drew a blast of a kick. He drew a blast of a kick at the ball. And he caught me, Denzi, and waistcoat. And he took every button that was in my waistcoat out of it. That was near. There's no lie in that. That's the truth.
That was a close one.
Okay. Well, gentlemen, we'll move on. We appreciate you coming here this evening and enjoyed your little chat to bring back memories of that 50, 60 years ago. We'll move on tomorrow to the playing field, the present playing field, which is known now as Crawhall's. It's so proud of you to come here. This is the centennial celebration of the Gaelic Athletic Association. And you did very proud, and you should be very proud, of the way you have the village looking for the tidy towns I might interject here this evening. But tomorrow, please God, I hope that you all will be at the playing field out the road here tomorrow to see the crowds of people. At 2 o'clock, I believe, if my memory serves me right, there's mass for the deceased members. So until then, we will say good night and God bless you all, and we'll see you all tomorrow. We are very, very proud to have you all here after that long, long years, especially that old boss over there in the corner, 88 years of age. Thank you very much. Thank you. We are at the crossroads of Bala on the main Galway Banlasloe Road. July the 29th,
This is the centennial celebration year. We're now approaching the graveyard in Menlough, where the masses at the local church for the deceased members of the 1936-38 football team. We thought it appropriate at this time to just pay a visit to the graveyard, seeing that the mass is for the deceased members going on at this time in our local church. It is somewhat overcast today here in the parish and through most of the country, I'm sure. Filming some of the new... As I was saying, some of the new homes that are being built in the locality. It's nice to see the buildings going up and the people staying, and the unemployment's still so bad. Of course, even though it's Sunday, the milk lorries got to work, pick up and deliver to Kilconnell. We're approaching the Punderbrone crossroads. I'm sure the people who are looking at this right now knows, without me explaining, the homes of Ruans or Nails. I just see in that car a young lad that played football with Menlough some years ago, Mick Neal. And this home here, Nocton's, where Bernie McHale now lives, a trainer and manager of, I believe, the 69 team. Crowell's home and Collins's, Mitchell's, and the post office. For those visiting Ireland this summer, whenever you will view this film, you'll see the Mollahan's here and the old school, now the dance hall, and the new homes that it's built here at Churchview, a beautiful sight. We're now approaching the church where Mass is now going on for the deceased members that I told you a few moments ago. Thronged with cars here today. As you can see, there's an overflow of people outside. There'll be great celebration here in a few moments when the parade will leave from this part of the village to the local football pitch, passing out the old barracks and now coming to Brendan Glenn's tavern. Across on the other side, it's a local museum. It's Mr. Dignan's, Paddy Collins there, post office. Jim Dignan's house and Thompson's bar and lounge. Sonny Burke's, now Paddy Joe Burke's, public house. You can see some of the places being redone and new walls for the tidy towns, and they certainly are doing a beautiful job. This is Divney's private house in Menlough. Menlough Beg and Tom and Maura McLaughlin's food store. And Jim Kelly's, now Rita and Michael Crowell's home. This here is Father Jarlett Kenny's home. And if we got a little closer, we could see his beehives in the back. This is the National School in Menlough, where most of the young fellows that you will see here today started their education. The new barracks here in Menlough, beautiful sight from outside. Not a nice place to be if you have to go inside. Mrs. Madden's home and the old home of Dick Madden also, now Gordon's food store. Looking across to Menlough again, taking a view back and behind us. Now we're outside Gus Melia's home. And that home there is now owned by Gavin's. It was owned at one time by the chairman of the North Board, Paddy Nocton. This is Sean Harrison's home and funeral home. Approaching is a great footballer at one time, the famous Mun McIlwain. Mun and his two brothers, now deceased, Bob and John McIlwain. We're approaching, as it said, Caith Míle Fáilte. 100,000 welcomes to everyone. Yes, as I was saying, until we passed it out, the sign that reads Caith Míle Fáilte, 100,000 welcomes to each and every one of you today. And looking up to the football pitch that has been here since before I went away myself, and it's still looking very good today. In a half an hour from now, I'm sure this place will be thronged with young and old. Looking ahead again, looking now towards Vermont. And now, as we look across to Gralia, everything is beautiful and green. The corn is ripening, and the potatoes blooming. Fine field to beat there. This is Sean Potter's house. I see some people waving at the door. And this is the Hill of Vermont. My old homestead. The home now of Jim Higgins all the time for over 60 years. Things are quiet now there. Now, the old Tom Lyons house at the back. This is Paddy Joe Mannion's new home. And next we have Seamus Monahan's. Another new property. A few more properties out here. All new homes here in Vermont. The home of another Brendan Glenn, this one from Gralia. Straight across you can see where this is Dan O'Connell's, a returned Yank, connected to the Carrolls. And if you look across the fields, you can see the home of Frank Dolan, Frank and Paddy Dolan. Frank played in the 1936 county final. This is Michael Carroll's home here.
Dancers leaving after the stars were gone.
Lovely ghost.
Many a heart was aching. If you could read them all, many a hope had vanished after the ball.
All right, ghost. We'll see you later. Good luck.
All I hate,
Tommy.
Centennial parade from the parish church in Menlough. It certainly gives me great pleasure to broadcast this with the help of Brendan Glenn's video. Says Menlough GAA Club, Galway for the McCarthy, is as far as I can see. I see Paddy McDonough there taking pictures, Maureen Maloney, the young under 16 and under 14 football team. John Harrison supplying some music. at the rear of the footballers, I see some fine GAA faces there. Mun McIlwain, Jimmy McGrath, Sean Kelly, Parik Nocton, and I see the tall, sturdy Paddy Ryan. Paddy Collins. It said Galway for the McCarthy, Offaly for the Briquettes. Tommy Quirk, Sonny Nocton, Frank Dolan. This is certainly a fine turnout for the centennial celebration, and Menlough certainly has done it proud. It's nice to see the young lads running up along the side of the pavement. Paddy Collins is having some time there trying to...
Hello, Tommy.
Hello.
All right, Tommy.
The man I was mentioning about last night was John Paul Carey, who we missed in the picture. You can see Tommy Quirk, Mun McIlwain, Sonny Nocton. My pint to John Paul Carey as we missed him there, John Mitchell. John Paul, we missed you. Gentlemen, Paddy. Hello, lads. Jack Collins, Parik Nocton there. His father did some great work with the GAA at one time, and Michael Byrne. The young ladies of the parish, Kathleen, hello there. And our local guard, the Shikana, with Brendan and Alan and TJ. Paddy and Mikey Mitchell and TJ Scanlon. There's Pat Flynn and Eddie Quirk, TC Mitchell, Seamus Monaghan, and the McDonoughs. The Lawless is there in Bala. Collins's and Ruens. And across the road, Paddy Dolan, John Kilgannon, and Sonny Carey. You're doing them proud today. It's lovely. How are you, lads? Yeah. And Maureen, how are you? How's it going? How are you, fellas? How are you, Paddy? How are you, lads? Lovely hurling.
Are you on colour?
Yes, we are. You are now, not me. It's your day today. Back again to Jim Higgins there, Teresa Mitchell, Michael John Lally, Paddy Joe Kinney, Mrs. McIlwain, and Anne, and Larry Duffy.
Hi, Jim.
And there's Binny Raftery. Keith Mila Falcha, 100,000 welcomes once again. John Potter, how are you? Warwick Flattery and Maureen. Oh, yeah? Just hold it there, Mr. Quirk. Where are you going? Checking out your disc there. Straight ahead of us there. Well, I see Joan Higgins and Mrs. Higgins, Della Raftery, and some of the other people I don't even know. How are you?
All right.
You all get your stuff and get talked out. I will now hand you over to our...
As you're saying, you can continue on talking, and I'll be talking here, but you won't hear me. Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, it certainly gives me great pleasure to introduce to you the centenary celebration for the Menlough GAA Club. It's a beautiful day. The sun hasn't come out yet, but looking around about the pitch here in Menlough, the crowds are fantastic. We will be doing a lot of talking for the next couple of hours, but first of all, I would like to hand you over to the secretary of the Menlough GAA Club, Mikey Mitchell.
I'm his body and join you on a nor a horse to come and load land for you. Funny you want coming short here and clean on him. He's the guy of the body over here and he's coming to the Yaku. And short of you being talked about, for sure I've got dinner. Why don't you for sure go and lift the stoggage of Harry cooking doon, stoggage and brush the dutta, and there, Father Napton, Harry Cognapton, a honey cooking, vetch, and screen from all over the fence and the honey hooking of Venezuela. I can tell them all, the Flynn, and the good Shancho, for sure over there. For sure.
Mikey Mitchell speaking in Irish here.
For Shancho,
at this centenary celebration, as I had said a while ago. It's getting very overcast here today. And a strong breeze coming up. But it certainly does you good to look around and see such a fine crowd of people who turned out for this beautiful celebration. 100 years of GAA. An applause there for Jim Higgins.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Michael.
Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Gaels alike, it is with pride and happiness I welcome you all here today in my capacity as chairman of this old club. A club that has shared our fortune in good times and bad for a long, long time. The first match under the rules of the GAA was played in John Lohan's field in 1896 against Kilkenny. That's neither today or yesterday. So when I welcome you, I do so in the names of generations of Gaels long since left us. Many of them, of course, remain with us. I also welcome you in the name of the Association, a sporting organization that can equal the best anywhere, whose aims and objectives are to preserve and foster the cultural pastimes of our people, and to instill in all of us a love for those pastimes. This association has preserved for us a large part of our heritage and passed it on to us as a living entity. Enjoy it and pass it on to our children, we must. And when their time comes, they will also pass it on to their children. In that way, as the GAA is perpetuated. This brings me to the strength of the association itself. They are in every parish, in every half parish in this country, who today are engaged in so much the same activity as ourselves, remembering the terror of the past and looking back on their achievements. The first big win that this club had was in 1936, when they won the junior county title and brought it home here to Menlough. Quite a number of those stalwarts are here with us today, and we are very appreciative of those who have travelled long distances to be here. We thank them very sincerely. I will not single out any of those particular players. I did not know them, I never saw them playing, but there is one individual whom Mikey Mitchell here, our secretary, has already mentioned. And I think that he will epitomize the spirit of the GAA in this present year. I refer to James Higgins out there on the hill. He certainly hadn't too far to go for a kick of the ball, and he did that often enough, I am told. His is a spirit that will keep this organization going if we can engender that in the youth of the parish and indeed the youth of the countryside. That's the type of person who would not take no for an answer, who kept the flag flying in all types of weather. And may he do so for many a long day to come. Our thoughts will always be with you, Jim. I single out one of those to pay particular mention of, and in doing so, I will be paying tribute to all of those who have died and, as I said, are no longer with us. I would refer to the former chairman of the North Board, the late Paddy Nocton.
We're standing here in the football field in Menlough, and we missed a few people here the other day. One of them beside me is John Mitchell, and John is going to explain to you the people who played with him in the 1927 team. Later on we'll get to John Paul Carey, who we missed also the last day, and John will give us his rundown on the 36 team. First of all, John, you're very welcome.
Thank you, Mr. Higgins.
Tom's good enough. Listen, do you remember the 27 for a minute?
Well, I'll give you as many as I just can remember of.
Yes.
Well, I start in Vermont first. Pat Rowan, your father, Jim Higgins. And Francis Dolan, John Nocton, Sonny Nocton, Jim Mannion, the mill, Glantan.
Yes.
And let's see now. Am I finished there now? And I see that quarter.
Yes. Five or six of them here.
Yes. Paddy Nocton, chairman.
Yes, Chairman Nocton.
Right. Yes. Tom Ward, the Lord of Mercy. And Robbie Kelly, he was in goal one time. Good gory he was too. And I had them all there a few minutes ago. Now I got to do it. Let's see now. Did I get to... Oh, there was a Patrick Quirk.
It's Paddy Quirk in Menlough Bay.
Yes, it's in America now.
Yes.
Jack Gormley, Paddy Gormley, he was playing at the time.
Bobby Clark.
He did, but I don't know if he played that time or not now. Would you give him that name?
It's going back pretty far, isn't it?
It is.
You're great to remember that, that many, and sure, maybe in a few minutes you will be able to think about the two or three more that you said up to 14 or 15.
I did get up to 14 or 15.
Is it true you were playing with 21 or 15 at that time? Was it 21 players as you had in those days?
No, 15. It was 15 then. Oh, it was 15 then.
I was told that they started out first with 21 players.
Oh, that was years back. Yes.
Farther back than
farther
you
the
can
back,
remember.
Yeah, I can remember.
All right, John.
I can even remember the team that they played for.
Menlough played for?
Yes. After forming that team up.
Who were they? Do you
the
remember?
The Celtic, I do. And they played it in Lawless's Field right across from your house now.
Martin Lawless's Field?
Yes, Martin Lawless's Field, yes. And the score was 2 points for Menlough, 1 for Caldera.
My God, almighty, you can... First of all, now, I'll go, John, for a few moments because he's running out of tape, and thank you very much. We can stay there. John Paul Carey, you're very welcome. How are you?
Fairly good now. How's yourself?
Not too bad. The 1936, is that when you remember back, John?
That's when I played Menlough.
Oh, you played Menlough that year?
We won the county championship.
You were the county champion.
Yeah.
Do you remember anything in particular on that day?
I remember it was a tough game. We were lucky to win it. Jim McGrath wasn't a goal for us there. Munmack, full back.
Yeah, I heard them saying that the other day.
Yeah, John Mack. Lord of Mercy, my man. Yeah. Bob Mack. Maureen Dolan, centre field. Where did Johnny Carty play the Lord of Mercy at that time?
don't know.
Forward line, I think. Forward line. Yeah. There was Junior after it. There was Jack Kelly. Lou Sweeney. Peter didn't play in the 36. Bernie Fahey. I see now. We had two lads from Dunmore the same day.
Yes, that's certainly names we didn't get the other day, and I'm glad that you came along, John, and John Paul. And we will be talking to you on here later on, but this will be on tape, and it will be there for another 100 years anyhow.
I know.
We certainly are glad you came along.
Yeah.
We will talk to you later anyhow, gentlemen.
Yeah,
thanks very much.
Thanks very much, Mr. Higgins.
Yes, Liz, how are you?
Good.
Joe Cosgrove, is it?
How are you doing?
You know something, it's a year or something since I've seen you, Joe.
It's nearly now, shortly.
Tom,
you're not good.
Very glad to meet you.
Where are you now? I'm in Ballinair.
Certainly a fine...
Still great boy. Great boy.
Listen, we're moving on here, lads. We didn't talk to you the other day, Eugene, did you? We talked to Mike.
Yes.
Tommy, you have your back to the camera. I don't know why you're doing something like that, because it's a very special day. You're looking up front. No, Jimmy Mitchell, get over here.
I got you a job around you.
Yes, I know that.
Yesterday you knew when he was bouncing for you.
I see him trying to hide. There's a lady getting in there, and I see Kathleen Cosgrove right there in the back. We were just moving around about, and you'll see it tonight anyhow. We'll move on. How's the day going anyhow, Tommy?
Jesus, you know something, you're talking to them, it's fighting, nothing is going on.
Well, I don't know whether he has it on or not, anyhow.
It's rolling.
Let's move around about anyhow, because it's running out of tape today. But there's certainly a fine crowd here, isn't there?
Oh, it's lovely. It's lovely crowd.
It's going to rain, I believe. Get the match on.
Put them going, that's what you should do.
Yeah. We'll move on anyhow. We'll see you later, lads. Good luck. Yeah. How are you, Tom?
Tom,
and Mrs. Jordan, how are you doing? How are you? How are you doing?
How are things?
How are you, Mike? How are you, Tom? I'll shake your hand,
too.
I know it will,
That's another one I forgot.
Who's Murray? Paddy Murray, we got him last night.
Oh, did you? No, yeah. That's all right.
I'll be back again in a few minutes.
You
I will, yes. Yeah. All right, how are you, lads?
Well, how are you doing?
We seen you yesterday, didn't we?
Yeah.
We didn't see you, Paddy, yesterday.
We did not.
Certainly a lovely day, isn't it?
Yes, you know.
Fine crowd, but... Would you believe I thought there'd be some more people here?
No, I suppose there isn't all that much for sure.
There isn't that much for sure.
No,
no. It's not bad, I suppose.
No, it's not too bad. Sean Kelly and Matty, would you move your back a little, Matty? We talked to these gentlemen over here.
Yes.
How are you, Sean?
How are you, Tommy?
Hello, Tommy.
How's it going?
Not too bad.
The old ship is going fairly well.
We missed you the other day in at the tape in Menlough. I thought Sean would be around.
I wasn't there at all. I wasn't there that day. It's your time enough. You'll be there now.
We've seen a picture of you, Sean. You were in the 54 team, weren't you?
I was, yeah, 44. I was just 40 years ago. I have a medal for the 44.
Yeah, but we had you in a picture there with Sean and Harrison. That was a 54.
That was a 54. Yeah. That was the time John Joe Crapple was out there.
That's right. That's right.
That was 54.
You were still a very, very young man.
We won an odd board again in 1947.
We didn't even hear about that at all.
We did. I have medals for them.
We'll talk to you later. We'll go over here to the left and talk to you in a few minutes. All right.
How are you, Brian?
How are you, Sean?
How are you, Tommy?
How are you doing? And Patty.
Oh, Tommy, how are you?
And that's John. Thank you.
We've been on time.
How are you,
John? How are you?
You don't even remember me, do you?
No, I don't. You're Higgins.
That's right, that's right. One of them, all right.
One of them.
Yeah. Tommy. Yeah, I'll be talking to you anyhow later on. Okay, we'll see you later, lads. Another young Carey, but that's a different Carey altogether, isn't it?
What is that?
That's an uncle, is it?
An uncle, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I didn't even know how you were connected. I knew you were connected somewhere, but it was your son or not.
Yeah.
And Sonny Knocking, you didn't even talk to me the other day. What the heck?
I did talk to you. I want to talk to you.
You didn't say too much, though.
I didn't, because, and I tell you, I didn't say anything big lot.
How are you?
I could have said more, you know.
Yeah, you didn't even, who's these? Is this your one?
No, Michael
Carey. Michael Carey. Yeah. Oh, jeez, I didn't search that for him from myself. Are you Michael Carey's young man?
No, Sean Carey.
Sean, from where?
County Down.
County Down? God, you came a long way. County Down. And is that your little sister?
No.
No? She's a Montpellier lady too, is she?
Yeah.
Now it looks like it's going to come rain. I better move on.
That
This is the Menlough under 16 football team. I really don't know any of them.
Right on.
Darren, Matty, we'll see you.
Sean,
Sean Harrison. Sean Harrison. Sean Harrison. Sean Harrison.
You can look out there and see an old veteran refereeing this match is Paddy Joe Kinney. That's young number three off in a solo run and send it a mile wide. You want to go out and give them a hand, Paddy?
I know.
Who's that young Maloney, is it?
Yeah.
Young Maloney and young Kit, is it?
Is that young Kit, maybe?
Young Kit is number 10 there.
Yeah,
that's
great.
Young Maloney.
Young Jellyvian, number 6. And who's Maloney, the blackhead lad, is it?
Yeah.
Which Maloney?
Matty Maloney's son in grass, yeah. And do you know those young lads there?
I don't know one of them.
He's young Kelly, young Kelly Obama, I think.
Quirk and Winfield, is it?
Winfield,
yeah.
Sure, you have...
There's only 20 minutes aside.
Who's playing the next match, Paddy?
The girls, I think, is it? Tilly.
Yeah. Camogie. Yeah. We'll wait to see that.
Jung Hoban.
Ralph! Paddy Joe Kinney there getting in some difficulty. A throw in.
Ralph!
Milo, how are you?
Jung Kitt again.
Is it John Kitt's son, is it?
Yeah.
Don't be taking us now.
Oh, very good.
Very good, man.
How are you?
That's what I was telling you all ago.
I did not talk to you very good.
You did, and you can't to me.
Who's your sister that was there? this lady here. I don't even know this lady.
She knows. God bless her, your dear son. But you got off, can't tell me.
Yeah, I didn't get fat, I got heavy.
Well, what is bad that is worse?
I wish to give me the names here.
Yeah. I know some of them are already done
that.
Oh, be Mr. Barney Malone. Michael Carey, how are you?
down here, Thomas. Leave it on there.
Ger Conley kicking out the ball there now.
Ger Conley from where?
Right. And that's Young Gormley. Off the solo run. Very good.
Waterloo.
Very nice centre. Into Michal Flattery. Very good. Nice centre. Into John Laffey. Martin Hooman has the ball now. Ready to clear. Very good clearance by Martin Hooman. Into Gerard Harrison. Gerard misses. And Kevin Collins collects the ball. Now he delivers it to who in the hell is that for? Oh, Sean Screen. Sean Screen. A nice ball into the forwards. Now that's Patrick Gormley with the ball. Unable to clear it. Tommy Screen going up for it now. Takes a shot. And it's wide. That's kind of hard to think of. Yeah, that's Gabriel Collins. I know that fellow, all right. Into Martin Hooman. Out to Jerry Harrison, intercepts there and sends in a nice kick to the foul line. Jerry Connolly comes out from his goal, clears it out to Pat Gormley. Pat Gormley is going to solo now. Sends it on to Michal Flattery collects and sends it back upfield again. Into John Potter. John Potter has the ball now. Goes in a solo run. Takes a shot. Into a Parry Kerrity. And it's a goal. A goal by Young Hughes. I was expecting a much bigger crowd. Now Madden Hogan kicks out the ball to Gabriel Collins. Gabriel collects, sends it down, the passes into Bernard McHale. Bernard is going into the send it into the foul line now. And his goal is wide.
Speaking of Bernard McHale, that's the son of Brisbane.
Oh, definitely. Because Bernie is a great help to us, like, and especially in the catering and as well.
Yes.
As training the junior team here, he does a great job on them.
I missed you.
And referee Kinney, Mr. Kinney.
That's the famous Betty Joe Kinney.
That's his backline for Menlough. Right. We'll be going back on 30, 35 years, would we?
My God, is it that Lynn?
No, Bernard has the ball.
I don't think he'd like to hear you say that now.
And the Gabriel Collins takes
a
shot.
Through, and it's a goal.
And it's a point.
A point.
I say it's a point. Now, John
Hanson. Fairly low there, isn't it?
Yeah.
But Paddy Joe, speaking of Paddy Joe, he did play.
Paddy Joe was a grand player. Very hard to play Paddy Joe in his day, like 7 or 8 years ago. Paddy Joe finished up football. Now it's half time.
Half time. If you happen to look over there, it's very possible. Pat Moore, you know, I haven't talked to Pat in a long time, or a lot of you lads. Is there anything you would like to say here on this special occasion, Pat?
Well, today I'd like to say that it's one of the best days of our lives to come together here, Menlough Club that has achieved so much since its foundation in the 1880s. And it's lovely to see all the old people here who played for Menlough, particularly the people of the 1936 team, and to see so many of them alive. And it's great to see the people of the 60s and the 70s coming back and having this day out together.
Certainly is.
And I think the unsung people of Menlough are the people who, throughout the years, in good times and in bad, organised the club and kept it going in bad times. And we remember them particularly today.
Very good. Nothing else, thank you for that. My love, Patrick. Is there anything you would like to say, my love, about the even the present lads? Or
there is one thing I'd like to say to the present lads, that we stick together right through the parish and try and do something. We are going fairly well at this present time, but for the last few years things have lapsed.
You're off now, for how long? I think how long are you on?
We're off 1 year. Year roughly. We came back this year. They have achieved going well in the league, and next Saturday evening, I believe we're starting the championship.
Very good.
And I believe that if they get their act together right, we could be back in the big time again.
Very good, my lord. Jimmy Mitchell, you were in the what? 69 team, is it?
67 and 69.
67. I didn't think you were back that. I didn't think you were that old.
Ah, we're getting old, but still in all. We are 69. Young in heart.
And you still play again today?
We'll tug out anyway, so.
You have to play. Paddy, you're very active, right?
Well, I was active enough. I came in around 62 when we reformed the club, like after it was elapsed for a few years.
Yeah.
And in 63 then we had a minor team, and myself and Father Mikey Quinn was in charge of them. I was secretary and he was training them. And Pat Moore and all these fellas here, and they were the team that led up to 1969. We played the first round below in Mumbai in the minor again at Haskell, and we beat them. And then we played Ballyghair in the next round. And we played Caltra, and we played Danimady, and we got in the final against them all, and they beat us a couple of points in the final. But I think McNair was the captain of them, Pat Moore, Sean Moore,
any of those fellas around today?
They're all around today. They were nearly all, there was about 10 of them on the team in 69, and they're all back here again today.
You said Mickey Moore, is Mickey Moore here today?
Mickey isn't here today, no, Mickey can't be here with us. But Mickey wasn't on that minor team, no.
Yes,
Sean and Pat was in it. And Joe Cosgrove, not together.
I think Joe, all right.
Yes,
it was
Joe.
Good to think that when people like Pat Moore would go away, that you would still...
Yes.
Keep the flag flying.
Well, we kind of keep together. We're sort of an old party of our own.
And Michal,
Michael,
would you like to say something about this special day?
Well, what do
Michael was in England, I think.
Well, in 69, when you won the county title in 69,
yes,
I was playing for Sean McDermott at Birmingham at the time, you know?
Yes.
We went to the county junior final and got beaten by 1 point in that junior final in 69. So I was misfortunate since that I missed out the 69 victory that you had here, but I came back and I played first junior with Menlough in 1970 and senior as well in the Rhine Cup, and I played under 31 as well in 1970 with Menlough.
Very good.
Sean McDermott, the team I played with at that time, won 6 county championships, Warwickshire county championships, following 6 years after leaving, so maybe that's the reason they're winning. But anyway, I played with the Menlough team in 74 when we were beat Spittle in the county semi-final, and you know that famous objection.
I heard about the famous objection, all right.
So went on to win a Montpellier Junior League medal with Montpellier afterwards, and played championship football with Montpellier since as well.
Very junior good, Michael. We're very okay. glad to have you and your father here again today, and I was very glad to see your father. Okay, I'll see you later.
Thanks.
Not too bad. He's here today.
How long? Oh, since 1957.
1957, my God, my, it's a long time ago. But you were hurling here before you ever left, weren't you?
Yes, I
certainly
played for Skehanna for about 6 years.
6 years. Yes. You're great. I remember seeing you playing here all right before ever I went away, but I'm so happy that you're around here for this special occasion. And speaking of hurling, if we move over with the cameras over to the girls, the Camogie girls are starting off with their first match, I believe, in years here today.
Very good.
So we'll see you, we're moving on, we'll see you later on.
Okay, thanks very much.
See you later. Good luck, thank you. Bye-bye. How are you, Patrick?
Not too bad.
How's the curtain? All right?
Okay.
I didn't see you in a long time. Turn around this way. Turn around this way and we'll talk to you for a few minutes.
Yeah.
You cannot hear me, can you, too well? We're on tape now, by the way. Who's the lads in yellow? They're both Menlough lads.
And that?
Yeah, but this is a very special day, isn't it? Very nice day in here today.
Oh, glad.
Really lovely.
Great day.
You don't remember the 1936 football team that we talked about? Do you?
I do.
Sure. Do you?
When you don't, it's a missed day.
That's right.
I wouldn't.
It's a long time ago, but I didn't think you'd remember back that far.
Oh, when was your daddy playing?
Yeah, he was playing in 1926 and 27,
yeah.
Up to 31.
Sure, there was sure all the team.
Oh, he's been local.
Potters and all, they might
have
Potter and...
Well, they were a newer one now.
Newer than Paddy Nocton was in daddy's.
That's right,
Paddy
that's
Nocton,
right.
Paddy
right,
Nocton. Yeah. Well, Paddy Dolan, get them some...
To you?
Yeah. You don't remember, do you?
Well, Jimmy McGrath was the goal, right?
Oh, Jimmy McGrath?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Of course, your Frank was in there. You didn't win there yourself, no?
I'm old. No, I only played one game in the whole game.
One game and they put you off, did they?
No.
No?
No.
Think
well,
they
would? Well, one of them. Oh, my God, we did win, huh?
So you won that game. And you didn't get any score that day, did you?
No, they have.
Huh?
No. Did not. Didn't come yet, Johnny.
Well, maybe after a while. Maybe after a while.
Another man, Brendan. Another year.
Oh, yeah. Do you see this fellow up here, Paddy? Paddy, on tape. You're on tape now there. So we'll see you tonight in
Glen. I'll get you later,
yeah. All right.
Oh, yes, right.
All right, we'll see you later, Paddy.
Well, I was the host for staff of the
lovely.
Huh? I was the host for staff of the whole team.
Come down out of there, Kelly.
I was staffing them up. I couldn't pass in my hands.
Oh, that's right. We mentioned that was mentioned here last night. All right, Paddy. That was very good. Paddy Mannion's, Paddy Mannion, Bachall, he said down and gave them the first start.
Yeah.
Well, that was very good. That's right. Frank told us last night. Well, we'll move on, gentlemen, and thanks very much. We'll see you later.
Okay. We'll be sure. We'll be sure.
Oh, yes. No, you will not. We'll see you in Lanahinch. Okay.
And the banks of my own lovely leaves.
Yeah, bye-bye. Well, bye.
Sorry, Tommy.
You never even talked to me at all today. What's wrong?
Oh.
I know you're a busy man. But are you satisfied with the setup here today, or are you disappointed in the crowd?
More than pleased now. We're enthralled, really, by the amount of people who have come and the enthusiasm of the people that are here. And in particular, the day is beautiful.
Oh, the day is lovely.
We would like rain very much.
Oh, I know that.
I have to say,
not
hope,
for today.
Hopefully,
not for today.
It will keep
certainly
keep away
for
today.
A great bunch of lads to put on something like this. It's supposed to be on in every village, but I believe it's not. But this is a big undertaking, isn't it?
Well, I could say that it was a spontaneous effort, really. It started in a very small thing, and then it sort of snowballed. And if it had gone on for another week, I don't know, it would have become bigger than all of us. We'd hardly been able to handle it at all. But as it is, I think it's just at the size where we can just about carry the thing through for the day.
Just to handle, yeah. With medals now, when are you going to present the medals?
We'll be presenting the medals now to the underage as soon as this match is over. And I think there's something in the region of 40 medals to be presented to those young fellows.
Very good.
And the veterans then in the present day team will be after the main match in the evening, and we hope to make a presentation to Father Kenny at that time.
Yeah, I heard he was resting for about an hour and
he said that he would be back in a couple of hours time.
Certainly judging from the crowd down here, if we look just across here, if we can get a shot of it, it's certainly a fine, I don't believe since before we left. Over 20 years ago, I don't believe I ever seen a crowd in Menlough.
I'd say that, no, you could go back to the 50s, really.
We've seen a crowd like that. That's absolutely beautiful, because we used to say that time that there were 7, 8 deep, but they're certainly 10 and 12 deep today.
They are indeed.
It's lovely to see, and I just hope that this day will revive the GAA here in Menlough. And certainly have started off that way with the Camogie team, and I hope it'll flourish.
It'll flourish and set new things in motion.
Thank you very much, DJ, and we'll see you later.
Okay.
Come on,
John, move away.
Come on, PJ. PJ Cup, please. Gabriel Collins.
You will now have when your Secretary of Protector Medals, it doesn't have the
Tommy Screen.
Continuing here at St. Donagh. And the bare medals will have to be
Bernard,
taken.
Bernard McKay, please.
And get them engraved. Stating.
Charlie Connor.
Centenary year 1894. 1984.
John Hughes,
please. John Laffey.
Jerry Cook. John Potter. Yeah, Tomás Scanlon, my time. Paul Kirsch, please. He's not a minor, none of them are minors. Martin Curley, my watch. It's a minor only, isn't it?
Minor is now
has
been
presented,
put
and
throw themselves and hand on the jerseys to
the ladies.
That's
all for
minors.
I think that's the lot now.
Have you completed the minor team now?
Our team has been completed, and this is the under-16 team now. And we'll get the names from Martin Collins. There you are, Martin. Now, Martin, you'll do the same thing and tell us. Are you, Mr. Screen, you tell us.
Come here to me now. It's all back now.
John Hansbury. John Hansbury.
If you could, hold it on a moment now. If you could, okay.
John Hansbury. Brendan Quirk.
Brendan Quirk.
They got the before now.
Yeah, but you can give them back.
Line up now, all of you under
John Laffey.
It's a line up here. You know yourselves the team you belong to. And don't be shy.
Gabriel Collins. Jerry Quirk.
The middle for all of you. And if there's anybody
Gabriel Collins.
Who finds themselves without one.
Nicholas Hughes. Notify.
Don't double the notes. We're doubling the
notes. Des Kate.
Goodbye. Come on.
Jerry Kelly. Porrick Hughes. Kevin Collins.
Hi, Kevin.
Ger Jordan.
Ger.
Sean Kitt.
Sean.
Man. The future.
Martin Moore. Jordan Melliday.
And Liam. Under 16, now all of you.
Liam Cosgrove.
Who have played the under 16.
Liam.
Parik Erse.
Besides, if there's anybody who belongs to the under 16, under 18,
you've
only got to qualify for one.
Yeah.
He has done already.
Right. Under 14 now. Captain of the under 14 team.
Martin Hansbury.
It's your line up there now.
Keep
naming
them now.
Keep calling them now.
James Hood.
James Holt. Come on, James.
And Tomás Ryan.
Nice and lively. When you're your medal grade, you can...
Sean Monaghan.
Into the crowd.
And Chris Laffey.
talking to that.
Who's that young girl?
Yeah.
Mention the names of the young girl.
Jimmy Screen and Brendan Cosgrove.
Anybody who has doubled up medals,
Brendan Ryan.
One of them, you're only entitled to one medal irrespective of how many teams you have
participated. Right, sir. Lally, isn't it?
Yeah.
You mentioned the names if you can.
I do have the ladies at the other end.
Tyron,
the jersey is now and be lining out.
Would
you now hand them back? Please, anybody who has got an extra medal, would you hand them back? It was not intended to give you any more than one.
John Howard.
Anybody who
has
got more
than
one, would you hand it back?
Four.
Four.
Five.
I get five.
Here you
are.
Goodbye.
Michael
Hughes.
Umpires
and
you get your medal.
Yeah, this.
Round it off, though.
You got your medal.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
That's it. A few years ago, so I'd ask you to be making a start.
Not too bad.
Is that gentleman over there?
Yes.
Face the camera.
This is the result of what?
Double somersault.
Here, a few weeks ago.
Yes, sir.
What happened? Let me see this. Turn around here to the camera. This is the result of some rough tackle, was it here?
Rough tackle, yeah.
A few weeks ago. What happened? You broke your hand, Jerry?
He broke the wrist, yeah.
Broke the wrist. You'll be all right for the next game, will it?
No, I'm out. 29th of August is coming up.
It's coming up.
Yeah.
And the boots are going on.
All
right, Jerry. Listen, we'll see you later.
Bye.
All right, good luck. Bye-bye.
I don't know who that one is. It's not on, is it?
Yeah.
Oh.
Marcella Napton.
Marcella Napton, yes.
And it's out for...
Oh, go ahead, Joe.
I'm just listening to lower.
Turn it up.
I cannot turn it up.
Oh, yeah.
You're on. Go ahead. Don't touch that. Give me a little bit. You just name the middle. Pick it up now. Miles away.
Now.
Who's that now?
Miss Lansbury,
Come on,
how about
books about it?
Come on, kick it!
Just give me the name, Scream.
Kick it!
Regina Crowell, that's true.
That's young flattery, that one, right?
Mrs. Costelon.
Mrs. Milo Costelon, is it?
Yes,
oh,
yes,
that's
Milo.
That's my football.
Helen Bourke. For the Connie Flattery.
She seems to be pretty good, isn't she?
Yes.
Now, drive it.
Miss.
Oh, yes.
Come on,
I really don't know any of those names, so
yeah.
You'll just have to
Connie Flattery,
Connie Flattery
takes
again. Okay, the commentating will not be too great because I really don't know anyone here. I'm a stranger here today. I just know a few of those young girls, but that's about it.
Oh, Patricia Flattery,
that. And Marcella Napton there,
Miss. Marcella Napton.
I wouldn't want to see it going
through. Referee's getting in the way, eh?
Come on, Ginny, in. In, Ginny.
Now, there we go. Connie Flattery's on the ball again.
Connie Flattery is very good, isn't she?
Yes, Regina Hughes gets it away.
That's Nicholas Hughes' girl.
Tackled by Colette Broderick.
There's a bit of kicking here now today, too, isn't it?
Catherine Crawford comes in with a hockey stick to get it away. Patricia Flattery takes it up.
It never passes centre-field, does it?
Oh, not really.
There's a lot of kicking going on. Oh, that's a good swing there. Past
Mrs. Kelly takes it.
Maureen Maloney, Mrs. Kelly now.
High ball in there.
Mrs. Kelly's going in.
Mrs. Monaghan sent it into the goal, and it's a goal!
Mrs. Katie Monaghan sent it to the net.
Yes.
And that looks like a Hasgrove hook, didn't it?
yes. Real Dillon one.
Yes. She can't even believe it herself. Now the manager is going in to talk to the goalie, who is Kathleen Flattery, isn't it?
Yes, Kathleen Flattery, goalie, yes.
They're undecided whether they'll hit it out to Maureen Kelly.
A great shot there from Maureen Kelly.
A great save by Kathleen Flattery again. She's going to stay in, I believe. The ball is back in again, but the goalie is down. The goalie is down.
It's in the net,
but
goal.
I think the whistle, no, it's disallowed. Disallowed. The whistle was blown.
Square ball there.
The goalie was down there. Eugene Lyon, we'll have to put in Gerard Lyon and Eugene. Paddy, would you like to dance? Oh, yes, half time.
The bikes are all getting ready.
Stop!
I'll go back, sir. Do.
And Jimmy Mitch is going out talking today. Oh, yeah. That's grand there now. To be humble in the best that I can. We're now blocked off, you know. That young lad is tripping in my teeth. Still? I'd like to move down to Tamika.
How are you doing?
Oh,
I'm
all
right.
No break. How are you doing? You're very big. I think it's cut off now. He's not even filling with dog.
Oh, that's a nice one.
What do you think of it today, Frank? All right. They're not getting as many points as you guys, are they?
I know, but...
Huh?
I started from Morgan. Came a lot worse than this yesterday, you know. One of us was taken up from Bradley, the one of the Aaron Ordenmore.
Yeah.
And the palace around there.
They had it won, but they didn't get it.
That was sad. It's very quiet here today, isn't it?
It's quiet. We have always had a really bigger crowd. You have no good game.
Back here to this. Well, move on here a little bit. Well, I think we're on tape, but. Turn it down there. Usually, what are you going to say? I got him before. He's back there now. You're not going to say anything to me, are you?
No.
What's happening here today?
Yeah, it's very enjoyable.
Nice crowd, isn't it?
Well, very nice crowd here. And I think... centenary, anyway, you know. We have... As you see here at the moment, our camogie for the parish, I think we have a very, very, very good experience of camogie for a mixture here in the parish alone, or in the Hare parish.
When did you have the last camogie team? How long ago?
Well, that I couldn't tell you now, Tommy, because I have not heard about. I'd say it must be way back.
Way back here in Menlough.
I'd say so, yes.
Well, I'll move on down the line. I'll see you later on.
True, yeah.
Okay, bye-bye. Right. Gentlemen, back again. And gentle lady. Is this Denise?
It's Denise, yeah.
It's Paddy Cobbles here, isn't it? Yeah.
What's your name? Josephine.
Josephine, how are you, Josephine? The tape's coming out there unusual. Is it all right? Yeah, okay. What do you think of the day, Josephine?
Very good.
You should be out playing out there.
Oh, yes. Turn around.
Your sister's out there, isn't she?
Two.
And why aren't you out there yourself?
I don't want to get any black marks.
Oh, jeez.
You,
huh? You have to get them. You have to get them sometime, right? It's a little dull today, isn't it?
It is, yeah. It didn't rain, though.
I'll break my tape there.
Move back there, okay. Okay. Mikey and Sean and DJ, you'll have to just tell us who's he's filming this now. We just want to know who the names of the girls are, so one day, maybe in 50 years from now or 100, that you will be able to look back and say that's Eddie Cohen's daughter or whoever the case may be. Now, if you just can, even the three or four of you, if you just can mention who's had the ball or who's hitting it. I see Mrs. Castle and Milo Castle's wife giving a belt to the ball there. And the...
Will you do this for me?
You don't know those numbers up number four, do you?
I'm
in an awful position. There's Marcella Norton. Battery girl. And I think the lady that got the goal.
Good morning, Kelly, with the ball. Maureen News Sky says.
It's a goal, it's a goal.
It's a goal, yes.
Marcella
Norton, scorer.
And I see that danger woman, Mrs. Monaghan, there up in the forward line again, isn't she?
Yeah.
Number 19.
Yes.
Connie Flattery with the ball.
The green and gold must be winning. That's a great football, yes, isn't it?
Very good.
We're
Catherine Crawford. Catherine pulling on the ball. Yeah. Bringing it out.
Great save, great save.
Very good save.
The goal.
The goal.
Yeah, the goal.
Margaret Castle.
Who's in the goals down there? It's the quietest camogie match I have seen in a long time, but this is their first day, of course, and therefore won't be much bloodshed, and sure it's good that it would happen at a day like today.
It's a bit of a switch in the team. 70-yard shot there over the bar, Connie Flattery.
Is that right?
Yeah.
The referee is having a field day today, isn't he?
You sure? That might be.
What's happening here now, TJ?
The puck out.
Puck out here.
I don't know who the one in goal is now.
Who?
She wanted to hear with us.
Oh, Mrs. Castro hit the ball back in.
The ball back.
It's over the line.
Over the line.
Line ball. That's a good book out to centre field. I think the ladies in green are winning so far, aren't they?
Yeah. Marcella Lachlan.
That's a bit of
number 16.
A nice pick up.
Yes, Molly Lally.
Kelly.
Kelly Flattery up to.
Burke,
Mary Hughes, Cliff Broderick, in out again. Connie Flattery with the ball now at the moment. Connie down along the field.
It goes out to mother that's in goal up on the other side.
It is,
it?
Yeah.
Well, Kathleen was very good camogie player years ago.
So I believe, yes.
And
that's right.
Then Maureen Maloney and
Maureen
like
Maloney, I think you had Maureen Lally as well.
That's right, some fantastic camogie players. I remember those myself when I were up in Jack Maloney's field. Those games were played.
One stage there, one was Vera Lally.
That's right.
She's not here today. I think Vera, she was very good.
God, there's some tackling here in the goal mouth, and the referee had to call
free out
before some shins would be blackened. Oh.
Run it in between them here now. Wide in the head.
Yes.
Wide.
It's a wide ball. All right, David. On record now, so I want to do them now.
My God, I think I'm going to be famous.
Yes.
I'm going to be famous.
This will be a tape for all time. 100 years' time, you can come back and watch that. And certainly when we see this little boy, it's very possible with the technology, the modern technology today, that this little boy will be around in 100 years' time. What's your name?
Hello.
Listen, a bite. I want a bite myself. And you can give it a bite too. All right, what's that?
Alan. Alan. Hello.
Alan who?
Alan Malone.
Okay, Alan Malone. We'll be back to you in a minute.
Alan McDonough. Cleb Broderick. Arcella Nocton.
Catherine Crockwell.
Karen.
Karen
Malone.
Maureen Kelly. Oh, Malone.
Maureen Kelly.
Kitty Manahan.
Mrs. Manning, you're demolished.
Anne Hughes. Una Ryan. Trish Owens. Karma Kelly. Fountain Men. Karen Burke.
Helen Burke.
Aline Owens.
Sorry.
Margaret Costello.
That's Milo Costello.
That's right.
Mary Cunningham.
Jacqueline Hoban.
All right, we got everyone there now, thank you. Now they're going to get medals in a few minutes. Oh, we got a few more here in the back. No.
Connie Fletcher.
Connie, who is the one that demolished those people, weren't
they? Just Fletcher. Edna Lally.
All right, we got them all now. Lovely. Thank you.
Hello, I'll present the medals to you. John Harrison was next to Jason. Milo Costello was the first. We want to get the jerseys from you as soon as possible. The yellow jerseys, please. Slight change of person.
Can we hear those names in mentioned of from the background of T.J. Spanlon?
And the next girl, Karma Kelly.
Well done, Karma. Anne McDonough.
Thank you.
Okay. Well done.
Colette Frosley.
Thank you.
Well done, Kill. Okay.
Eileen
Owen.
Kitty Crawford.
Fantastic. Eileen Owen. Very good job, Eileen.
Helen Burke.
Very good, Helen. Very good.
And another Karen Burke.
We'll have Camogie players yet. We'll have Camogie players yet.
Come on now, Will.
The yellow team.
Have you all got medals now?
They're nice, very nice. Lovely. Yeah, they
have
are.
All the ladies got medals.
The first one, and I earned it hard. It's the first medal I ever got that I won. I won three Connacht medals and I never got them.
Where's the other player?
The captain of the yellow team.
Captain.
Hello,
captain.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Collins.
Kathleen, I give you the first medal.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations. Kathleen. You're going to introduce your team now.
Okay. And you'll hand the medal out.
Margaret Costello.
Thank you very much. Very good game.
Mary Cunningham.
Okay, Mary. Very good game.
All the way up in Dublin.
Trish Owens.
Thank you.
Very good game.
Regina Crawford.
Okay.
Regina.
Very good game.
Connie Fletcher.
Connie. Oh, she's dynamite.
Connie.
Patricia,
come on. Patricia. All right. Very good game. Very good game.
Etna.
Okay. Very good game. Very good game. I got two more. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Thank you. Very good.
One in a long, long time, Captain. This is the first one. Since when you played here before?
Oh, it must be 30 years ago.
30 years ago. I don't
believe it. Like more. Maureen Maloney now. How many years ago, Maureen, since we played here in the scene? The 50s. 51 and 52.
And then you played up in Maloney's, your own field,
Before,
did you?
Years before that.
Yes. Will you be glad to bring this Mrs. Monahan with you in the new team? You will?
Yeah, love to. Sure. Oh, yeah.
She'll be your...
I have another medal, which is about 17 years ago since I won.
And this is the second
medal, I didn't think I'd add to it.
Certainly, I remember maybe 25 years ago. I'm not giving away my age or anything. Maureen and certainly Kathleen being two great Camogie players, and I wish that Vera was here today, and your sister Maureen were a great player.
Your own sister Bridie.
Yeah, she was fairly good too.
All those fine names.
Well, I'm glad. I hope that you will revive the Camogie team again with God's help. It'll be grand with all those young girls. And even the speed of Mrs. Milo Costello there, you'd have to bring it back.
Some great players.
All right, and thanks to Paddy, Mickey Collins, thank you very much to the referee. Thanks very much, Mickey. And Paddy Flattery, you'll be their coach. Thank you very much.
We've been waiting for the team of the past is taking the field.
Could you move back, lads? Move back from the line. Move back. Sean Harrison. Sean, get the 69.
I would also remind the spectator that the ball will possibly turn fairly fast, and it will be safer to keep your kids back.
You can't hear me out there, can you?
69 team leading across the field there now is led by their captain, Pat Moore, and on the other side you have Pat Carty. Paul is followed by Brian Nafton, who are a bit hidden there for me at the moment. Michael Jordan behind him, Joe Cosgrove, James Mitchell, Matt Hines, and our schoolmate of mine, Paddy Joe Kinney.
A nice round of applause there, ladies and gentlemen, to the 69 team.
Jersey, Michael Byrne,
Michael Carey.
Michael Carey, Sean Moore, Mickey Neal, Kevin Devney, Eugene Moore, and Michael Ryan.
Could the line up in front for a picture? People wants to get a picture of them.
One second.
Hold on.
Sorry. And if you keep the smile on at the same time. The background, starting on the left, Eugene Moore, Michael Byrne, the man with his very safe hands, Oliver Geraghty, Jimmy Mitchell, Michael Carey, Michael Ruan, and Bernie Costello. On the left, kneeling, Michael Jordan, Kieran Devney, Sean Moore, PJ Kinney, Pat Moore, Joe Falgrove, Brian Acton, and Michael Neal. Get them around. And let you keep the smile on. He still has the focus on you there. There are a few in particular I would like to refer to Noel Usher, who couldn't be with us here today. He telephoned Mikey Mitchell this morning and apologised for the fact that he wouldn't be down. He also intimated to him that he has been injured recently and he wouldn't be able to. On the 4th of August, I believe, this team is having its first championship outing. And for all of you listening to me, would come out and give them your support. We would all be very appreciative of it. On the left back row, Robert Harrison, John Ruane, T.J. Broderick, Colum Ryan, Alan Dagnan, Michael Owens, Willie Major, and a man who had a very unfortunate accident, who hurt his hand very recently, Jerry Lally. But for that fact, he'll be wearing a jersey today. Jarlett Cropwell, front row, the left, on my left that is now, Jerry Dooley. Jerry Gormley. Brendan Lynn. Kevin Flattery. Pat County. Pat Ryan. Corey Flattery. And my near neighbour, Del Zoll. If you get the fly going there for a few seconds now, give them a warm hand. And away you go for, I hope, what will be a very enjoyable game. And we'll get service in the club down through the years. If we want now, we'll have one.
Side. Paddy Joe, Pat Moore, Barney Costello, Ollie Gertie, Michael Byrne, and I'll get back to it later on, and the game is on. That's Michael Byrne. Get the long one down to Charlotte Croffle. Charlotte over to Pat Ruan, and Pat Ruan. Yes.
Hint and into center to Robert Harrison.
Robbie is our local and Robert Harrison
to Ruan, and
John kicks it in and it's well blocked down there by the goalie. And it's still, I think, is Brian Acton that blocked that one. And I'll do it. The ball is kicked out by Tom Lally. Brought down to centre field by Ollie Geraghty. Ollie, a nice long kick, and it's off the chest of Moore, I believe. Sean Moore, is it? And Michael Jordan has the ball now. He kicks it a high one at centre field. Paddy Joe Kenny is waiting for it, but didn't get it. It's Michael Jordan again. And Sean Moore takes a nice one across to Mickey Neal. And Mickey Neal takes a nice shot in. It's blocked down by Alan Dignan. Alan is hustled up there in the square. And the ball is out over the sideline. A line ball. Ball is kicked in by Mickey Neal, and it's Sean Moore kicks it, and it's gone wide. After a few minutes of play, no score. And I was just informed that it's Tom Cosgrove is the referee. A nice kick out there by Alan Dignan out to the centre of the field. Out to John Ruan. John sends it up the field to Des Lawless. Des is going through. A solo run, takes a nice shot, and it's wide. See Paddy Cromwell out there looking for a pin, but with the way the ball has been going now in the last few moments, he won't need any pin or paper. Great kick out there by Tom Lally, is it? Mickey Geraghty and Pat Ruane. Oh, there's a bit of tussle going on there, but still with Mick Neal and Paddy Joe Kinney, as you said. That's Pat Ruane, number 10. He's been pulled down there by Ollie Geraghty. And the referee gives a free to the present day team, as we will call them now. And Pat Carty is placing the ball. It's very humid here today in Menlough. Very overcast, as I stated before. Pat Moore is going up for the ball. It is Pat Moore, still has it. It's been blocked down there by young Dooley. Finds to get away, and a fine jump in the air there.
Oh, you're going to be beaten.
By young Ruane. That's Brendan Dooley. Brendan is on a solo run. And it was misjudged there. But Robbie Harrison is away with it. Crosses it out to Pat Ruane. Pat punches it into Des. Is that Des? No, it isn't. Now Pat Moore goes to kick the ball, and he's fouled there. And the referee was on the ball. Fast one taken there by Tom Lally. Tom to Barney Costelloy to Ollie Geraghty. And Sean Moore went up for it, but he's out there tussling with Willie Melia. And they're both claiming the ball. But the linesmen throw in the ball, and the referee calls the ball back. Taking a short free to Mickey Neal, and Mick sends it over the bar for the first point. First score of the game by the 1969 team. And it was scored by Mickey Neal. It still goes to show you that there's a lot of stuff left in these old lads. I haven't seen Barney Castro around for a long time. Doing very well today. Alan Dignan is placing the ball for the kick out. Now I say I don't know a lot of those players, so the names will not be correct. And there was a very short kick blocked down there. Pat Carty is moving away. Kicks a short ball to Colm Ryan. Colm takes a short one to Micheál Owens. Micheál is still away with it. He's still with it. He picks it up. Sends a lovely ball across the square into Brendan Dooley. Brendan takes a shot, sends it wide. 16. No score for the present day boys. Robbie Harrison went up well for that. Crossed it to Brendan Dooley. Brendan Dooley is off. Crossed it to Pat Ruane, or John Ruane rather, and Johnson Zidwine. Down by Robbie Harrison is on the ball. Pat Ruane lifts it up, number 10, kicks it into the square, and it's wide. Here's as we call them. I see Kieran Livney in there, but didn't get any of the ball yet, so I think Brendan Glynn and Sean Finn is going to volunteer after a few minutes. If there's not a score for the present day lads. Pat Carty's away with the ball for the local lads off to Jarlett Cropwell. Robbie Harrison. Robbie's been pulled back, but kicks the ball and still in play. Kicked out by Tom. Joe Cosgrove. Sorry, I've been mentioning Tom Lally. It is Joe Cosgrove. Michael Byrne punches the ball down to Mickey Neal, and the present day man is on the field. Michael Neal just misjudged that punch, and Pat Carty is away. Away with the ball. Robbie Harrison locks it down. Short little kick, but misjudged, and Barney Costello sends in a nice ball into Michael Carey. Michael, number 10, has been grabbed out of his hand by Pat Carty. Pat Carty sends a short one to Colum Ryan. Colum on a solo run, and short kick to Pat Ruane. Pat is off on a solo run again, crosses it up to Michael Parry. Michal Owens. And Michal is tussled there. Ball is blocked down by over the end line. Is that... Yes, it is a 50. Was that blocked down by Jimmy Mitchell there? No, it wasn't. Yes, Jimmy Mitchell. The referee calls the ball back to the 50-yard line, and Pat Carty is going to take this one. A nice kick. Dropping down close to the square. That's Barney Costello again, sending the ball out over the sideline. A line ball. A line ball for the present boys. Taken by Robbie Harrison. Short kick to Carl Owens. Sends it into the goal mouth. Is it over the bar for the first point for the present day boys? So the score is 1 point each. Out by Joe Cosgrove. Paddy Joe Kinney is there, but Paddy Joe hasn't got it. It's Robbie Harrison away with it, number 13, is it? Flat down with Michael, was that Michael Jordan? I don't know half of those players, but the referee calls for the ball. Yes, and Pat Moore has it now. Pat sends a long kick into Michael Carey. Michael Carey has the ball, kicks it wide. Kicked out to center field, brought down again by Michael Carey. Michael Rowan has it now. He crosses it into number 8. I don't know who he is, but the ball has been punched into Kieran Divney, and Kieran takes a shot. Kieran took a shot there, but the goalie saved it. And that was that could have been a big blow for the young lads if that ball went through that time. Mickey Neal takes a kick in, but down by yes. Yes, Pat Moore has it now from the veterans. kicks it across the field to McNeil, but has gone over line ball. The ball has just dropped down beside Bernie McHale, who has just arrived from Mayo, and he's a man that I wanted to speak to, so I hope that we can get Bernie back here after a while. He is the trainer of the present team, and wouldn't you know that Bernie would be in time. Bernie was the trainer of the 69 team, I'm reliably told, the 69 team and the present team today. So the people around Menlough are certainly very proud of a man like Bernie McHale. That ball has gone over the in line and wide. Ball being placed now. Brian Nocton kicked the ball out to Ollie Geraghty. Ollie turns around, a nice short one to Barney Costello. And Barney's on his bike. Barney kicks in a nice ball into Moore, but it's been palmed down to Pat Carty. Pat is still on the ball, crosses it to Jarlett Crowell. Jarlett takes a short one to Robbie Harrison, and Robbie is on a solo run. And you cannot put your hand on the ball on the ground. Trowan into the brother John to Pat. That one crossed the goal mouth. Knocked down by Michael Jordan. He's still on it. Des Lawless and Michael Jordan tussling for the ball and sent over the end line. Michael Byrne kicks it over the sideline and the line ball. Short kick into Pat Carty, was it? All brought down by a nice catch there by Barney Costello and a nice kick by Barney, the center of the field. Sean Moore is down. Kieran Dibney in there with the red dogs. And Kieran has been upended. Gets the free. And Mikey Neal takes a short one. But has been locked down by young Ryan. Ryan off Sean Rowan. Nice cross in to Dooley. Dooley, and away we go. Brendan Glynn, or Brendan, John Rowan that got that. That was a goal, I believe. Yes, John Rowan for the young lads. Score for the present day team, 1 goal, 1 point. To the veterans, 1 point. Getting very cloudy now at the back of us. I hope the rain will hold off. Ball has been kicked out. Holly Geraghty crosses it. Charlotte Crowell blocks it down. Hit John Rowan. Back now to Mickey Neal. Mickey number 5. The ball has gone over the sideline. Young Flattery there hits the ball. Short back again to Parry Flattery, I believe. Into Jerry Gormley. Jerry to Des Lawless. Des missed it. TJ Broderick crosses it, but it's blocked, and Pat or John Rowan has it now to Michal Owens. Michal Owens is on it. Oh.
Okay. Let me talk into it. Thank you. Because
you filming, David.
All right, David, you take a shot of the Joe Cosgrove kicking the ball out in the center field to Mickey Neal, and Mickey has it. Very sturdy young man is Mickey all the time. Ollie kicks it, a great kick in to Sean Moore. Is that Sean Moore? Sean crosses it in nice to his brother. And he's brought down there by Willie Melia. Ollie Garrity's taken this one. Short one to Mickey Neal. Mickey number five takes a shot, and it's wide. Well, someone signaled it wide, but it is the umpire now says that it is a point, and a point by Mickey Neal. So that's one goal, 1 point to 2 points in favor of the present day team. Alan Dagnan kicks the ball out. Michael Carey goes up for it. He gets it. Short kick to Mickey Neal. He blocks it down. He's solo run. Still on a solo run. Takes a shot in. Short one. Kieran Divney comes out. Kieran gets it. Sends it in across the square. And it's wide. I didn't think that Kieran Divney could move that fast.
No. He'll be moving a lot faster tonight.
He certainly will, but...
Well, he's a fast mover at any time.
He'll have more to chase than that.
He certainly will. You know that place in Galway, the Lost Causes Club?
Yes. Is that where he belongs to?
That's where you'll find him there.
Well, I often wanted to get him of a Sunday night, but I didn't know that's where you'd get him. So we'll... continue on with this, and John Rowan to his brother, right to Brendan Dooley, crossed in again to John Rowan, has been pulled down, and the referee, did he call it? Yes, the referee called. Referee, yes, Tom Cosgrove called for the ball. That's John Rowan, or Pat Rowan, took that one, sent it over the bar, and that's one goal and 3 points to 2 points. Well, the present day lads are ahead a little bit. But I wouldn't like to say too much before the end of the second half. Joe Cosgrove kicked the ball out. It's a low one, and it's blocked by John Rowan. Over to Michal Owens. Crosses it in again to Brendan Dooley, but Joe Cosgrove stopped it. Half time.
Picture in there. No, Bernie, I am...
Are we on?
Yes. Bernie, I'm very, very pleased to meet you, and I have met you some years ago, but the lads have told me that they are very, very happy with you here in this little village of Menlough. It's a very, very special occasion today, the centennial celebration. I'm so happy that you came back from your hometown today to see your own lads from 1969 and the present-day fellas. Can you just talk a few moments about the situation here around town and what you're feeling on today?
Yeah, well, I'm delighted to see such a big turnout. I'm delighted to see all the 69 team come back today. I think it shows tremendous loyalty that they have to their home club. And indeed, that has been the case always. Most of those fellas were placed throughout the country, and they always came back for games. even in 1969. And today is no different.
Transportation wasn't great that time either.
No, indeed, and it was expensive sometimes to get them back, but they were always willing to come. You would only contact them, and they were on the job straight away.
There were some of them in Dublin that time, wasn't there?
Oh, indeed, and some of them were guards placed around the country, and some of them teaching, and that. Yes, they had to travel much longer than they are now. The present team is mainly based in Menlough, and we haven't those problems.
It's much easier now for transportation.
Indeed, it is indeed.
Most of the lads have the cars, that time they had bikes, and before that they had nothing.
That's true.
Yes, well, that's very good. Now, do you have anything to say about the 1969 team, like in particular, in comparison to this present
team? Well, the 1969 team were exceptional in every way. It only happens once in maybe 50 years in a small parish like this that a group of fellows so dedicated and so good at football would be all at the same time.
Yes.
Available. That's not to say that the present team, and they're trying very hard, and indeed.
Hey, how's that?
Yeah.
This is better.
Yeah, man.
Great. Come on. How is it?
Yeah. Come on.
You all right? It'll be all right to get a little bit of McGinn, or you're staying on the team. I'm going to take it off. Maybe you'll take it over here and give a commentary on the team. Brendan, just a few words, but finish with this lad. Well, we're back here now again with Bernie McHale, that young lad just ran across the wire, broke the wire in us. So we're going to talk for a few moments, even though we're not on camera. We'll continue on talking here. Brendan still can hear me. He knows what's happening. Bernie, we're sorry there about the interruption, but the little kids have to enjoy themselves. Speaking again about the celebration, where were we when we were so rudely...
Well, we were speaking about the Pleasant team.
Oh, yes.
And conditions at the moment.
Yes.
And I was just saying that we have great hopes for the Pleasant team also. And they've been well proven time to be just as good or better than the 69 team. In fact, if they continue to win the matches, and they have won 4 matches out of 5 in the present league.
This year already. That's a very good record.
And they may well be involved in some of the finals. We hope they will.
Yeah, and when you see the enthusiasm of the people around about here today, doesn't it make you feel great to know that
indeed.
Such a fine crowd,
yes,
and we're people like
Paddy
Joe
Parish all united in this celebration, these celebrations today. I think it's wonderful.
And one of your men of 69, Paddy Joe Kinney, they're really rooting for him out there today, aren't they?
Oh, indeed. Well, he was always a special character and special enthusiasm, and raised the team all the time. On and off the field. And was always dedicated to training, and was here first man in every evening. Training was necessary.
Very good. And there he is again, the man we're speaking about, Paddy Joe Kinney. Now, Bernie, I'm going to let you go. And I let you enjoy to yourself to watch your present day and the men of 1969. And I'm going to leave now. I was very happy to be invited here. I'm sorry that things are going a little slow with the tape being breaking down and so forth. So until we meet again, Bernie, thank you very, very much. We'll see you later on.
Thank you also, Mr. Higgins, and thank you for all the effort you have put into this, because I'm sure it will help football and raise the standard in the parish.
I hope.
And
so.
Also, Mr. Glenn, for all the effort he has put into doing this video.
Thanks
and I hope
much.
That in years to come, it will be a source of joy to all the footballers who might be from the parish on big occasions, on winning matches. It will be something to show, and they'll be able to see and appreciate what went before.
Thank you very much, Bernie. Good luck now. Bye-bye. TJ. I'm handing over now to the present chairman, T.J. Scanlon, and he knows those fellas off by heart, the 69 and the present day fellas. So I would just like to say before I leave, goodbye and God bless, and we'll see you all again. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Tommy. And getting on with the commentary, there's Lawless, kicks the ball in there to Robert Harrison, who is pulled up for an infringement. The free to the 69 boys. Ball being placed there by Michael Byrne. Taking a good long run up to it. Kicks it now. Fetched very cleanly and safely there in the hands of Alvin Geraghty. Finds McNeil's wing, but Mick's a bit short on speed on this occasion. However, PJ Kinney slows up the progress there of Charles Crawford. The resultant free for the 69 fellas. There might be a small bit of prejudice on the part of the referee. However, he's doing a very good job. Ball being placed now by Pat Moore. He backs back, taking it. A fine free, well up the field, coming down to his brother Sean, and fielded by Barney Nocton, out to Ollie Geraghty. Ollie Geraghty takes a shot at goal. Unfortunately, his head has gone somewhat wide. Those fellows are remarkably fit, much fitter than I had imagined they would be. Certainly far fitter than I would be if I was out there. Not for that. They're considerably younger than I. But we have a very enjoyable game from those fellas. And Dagnino plays the ball, kicks it out into the centre of the field. Fielded nicely there by Robert Harrison. Passes it into John Ruane. again, who passes on to Des Lawless. A nice flowing movement there now into and past Ruane. Pat Solo is down the far side of the field and sends in a very nice cross, fielded by TJ Braddock, and he scores a point. A very nice movement there now. Nice flowing football. And demonstrates that if the fellows of the past can do it, so also can the boys of the present. Quite considerable interest in the game here today. There's a grand scattering of spectators, well representative of the parish, and indeed quite a number of people have come back for the game, travelled long distances, and we're delighted to welcome them. The ball kicked out in the centre of the field there, fielded by Barney Nocton, who is fouled, and the resultant free being taken by, let's see, is it Barney Costello? Barney Costello takes the free. No, he leaves it to Pat Moore. Pat Moore coming up now to face the ball, and the forwards going in, backs back, and a tight situation building up round the goal mouth now. Pat Moore comes up, kicks the ball, a fine free there from Pat Moore. Referee has a slight an infringement there, a push in the back on McNeil, and the resultant free to the 69 fellas. Ball being placed here by the sharpshooter of the 69 team, McNeil, whose ability at free taking was unparalleled in the history of this club. Accurately and sure-footedly as Mick taps it over the bar. The ball now being retrieved. Being placed in the spot by Alan Degnan, and Alan going back to kick the ball out. Sean Moore offering a bit of resistance in there. Takes a very fast and cheeky sort of shot, reminiscent of the Kerry fellas and the Paddy Holden and the Dublin Gold, or Paddy, what was the name of that? Paddy Cullen and the Dublin Gold some few years ago. David Glynn pulled me out of a bit of a pinch there. Thankful to you, David. Ball out in the centre of the field again. Fielded there by Barney Nocton. William Ailer on the prowl, collects the ball and fists it on to Kevin Flaherty, I'd say. Yeah, or Des Lawless it is. Pat Moore now going up for the ball, fields it solidly and passes it on to Oliver Geraghty. Well, a bit slow to grapple with it. And the ball taken away from Robert Harrison coming away now. Passes the ball out to Pádraig Flaherty, I'd say. Yeah, Pádraig Flaherty. Flattery from Eleshgale. Who is that number 18? Michael Owens, is it? Yeah, Michael Owens took a shot at goal there, and he was a bit unlucky. Have a way. The ball being placed now by Brian Nocton, being kicked out by Joe Cosgrove. Fine kick. Indeed, Joe always had a lovely free. Michael Burden fields it there and pumps it up into the air. Gary Owen coming down. Ollie picks it up. Jerry Gormley fields the ball and is making his way out. Pat Rowan now has the ball, passed into Pat Carty, sells the dummy there and is still going with the ball. Chips it into John Rowan, who is going goalward at a mighty rate. Ball blocked down in there. Great save there by Brian Nocton. Kicked out to this side of the field. Pat Carty on the ball again. Takes another blaster and Joe Cosgrove gets it away. Lovely stuff there now. Number of the 69 fellas here. It's confusing, really. Eugene Moore didn't really mean that now, but the ball moved rather than Jarlett coming into position. Jarlett gets the ball away. Pádraig Flattery soloing in the far side of the field there, passes out to his brother Kevin, and a free out. Foul pass there. A foul pass there now. We're waiting for the ball to come back. Tom Cosgrove, I must say, doing a great job in refereeing. Very sharp and really up at the game. reminds me of the cover he gave me when I played in goal and he played full back. He certainly kept the men out. Joe Calzo comes up for the ball now and kicks it into the hands of Pat Moore. Pass, a long relieving clearance way up the field into the, well, very near into the hands of Kieran Divney now. Barney knocked in there, going very high for the ball, bringing it down, but Barney Costello losing it. Pat Carty, an infringement there on Pat Carty, by Pat Carty, resulting in a free for Eugene Moore. The ball now being placed by Michael Neal on the spot, and as I said before, a sharper free taker we didn't have in Menlough before. A lovely ball, a beautiful ball there over the last. He certainly hasn't lost his old touch. The ball now being placed on the spot by our goalie, Alan Dagnan. All players now facing the ball. Whistle, the kick out, and a fine kick out there now, fielded by Michael Carey, who gets away from the ruck and passes the ball out here to the free there. I'm afraid I couldn't see what the foul was for, but I'm sure the referee had very good reason. The resultant free being taken by Pat Moore on this occasion, somewhat out of McNeil's range. Forwards in around the goal now, Pat comes up and a lovely free, a beautiful free, small bit of a tail in it, but it didn't turn until it went over the bar, and the umpire Julie signals it. Referee seems to be at wondering how the time is going. Oh yeah. The ball now kicked out into the centre of the field. Michael Carey breaks it down. Michael Byrne goes for it. Being interrupted there by Des Lawless, and Giles Crawford picks it up. And it is the pick up, I fear. The referee giving the free to Charlotte. And the ball now being placed by Pat Moore. Friendly exchanges there on the field. Although they look a bit sore to the recipients some of the time. Pat backs back now, comes up and kicks the ball. And another lovely free. Beautifully centred and into the very safe and lovely hands of Oliver Geraghty. Ollie gets the ball out to McNeil. Those fellas a bit short on speed, but certainly they have quite enough of polish. And with the finer points of the game all the time. They can still handle the ball very well. They're a bit slow on movement. The young lads seem to be feeling the pressure a bit much, and they're fouling rather frequently, much more frequently than you'd expect them. Over the barrier again now. That free was taken by, just, I missed who took it. That's certainly putting it up to the present day McNeil that took that free, and they're giving a bit of encouragement now to the older fellas. If I wasn't doing this bit of a commentary, I'd be in full voice myself, urging them on. A push in the back there now by Giles Crawford. Rather plainly seen, and they seem to be resorting to fouling at this stage rather than letting the ball do the work for them. Ball now being placed on the spot by Pat Moore, who gets it away rather quickly to Oliver Geraghty. Some scheme being worked up here now by the present And to Sean Moore, right in the centre. He feels it very well. He's battled up slightly there now. Still struggling on. William Ailia gets the ball and he's coming in with it. Referee hopped the ball, throw it in between them. It was really hard to make one's mind up there on who was at fault. McNeil now going for the ball, and Jerry Gormley, Kieran Divney has it back into McNeil. Mick takes a shot at goal, a lovely one in there now, and it's not wide yet. No, there seems to be it's a free out, I think. Yeah, a free out. Some square infringement there. And that about winds up the game. The referee blows the final whistle, and we've had a very enjoyable afternoons and tournaments from all of the teams, but in particular the present teams on the field, the fellas of the present versus the boys of the past. The score, the cameraman is asking me for here. I haven't it with me, but Milo Costello is keeping a record of the score there, wherever he is. Up to there. See what you see, Milo, there and get the yeah. Which one? Which is
which? 69 team were beaten.
69 team were the losers by 1-6 to 6 points. 1-5 to 6 points. Very close now, and a very enjoyable afternoon's entertainment. We must compliment all of the players, and indeed all who had or participated in this event here today. It was a wonderful success. We would like in particular to thank those who travelled long distances to come back and be here with us. We appreciate it very much and are very thankful to you. We will now adjourn to the presentation of medals, I suppose. Goalie! Emilia, come on, nice and snappy now. The medals are represented here by Paddy Crawford, Jerry Gormley. Soundman Jerry, Jarlath Crawford, Pat Carty, they're getting into place there. Colum Ryan, Robert Harrison, John Ruan, Pat Ruan, Brendan Dooley, Kevin Flattery, Michael Owens, TJ Broderick, Des Lawless, Subs, Patrick Flattery, Brian Acton, Sherry Lally, Tom Maloney and Joe Ryan. A big hand there for Jerry. Not that any of the rest of you are any less entitled to a clap, but he is special. The 1969 team. The goalie has already received a medal for the present. Has he not? I thought I read his name out there, Brian. Oh, fair enough. Well, that's proper order. There's a gentleman, Brian. Brian Acton in goal. Michael Jordan. Good man, Michael. You showed them a few faces out there today. Joe Cosgrove. You haven't changed a bit. My old friend from Raheans, Jimmy Mitchell. President of the club, special word of praise for him, PJ Kinney. Equally so for the captain of that outfit in 69, Pat Moore. Don't spare your hands.
and a fiery stalwart who I would rather as a friend than an enemy, Barney Costello. The man with the safest pair of hands in the business. I know I'll offend none of you when I say that, Ali Garrity. Michael Byrne, who was in no way short of heart. He might lack a little in class, but he certainly made up for it in spirit and willingness to perform. Michael Carey. Sean Moore. Come on, let you not spare the pause at all. Get him a good round of applause there. They've traveled a long way to be here with you and show your appreciation. Mick Neal. The man who has never lost his touch. And as I said on record, his sharpshooting abilities will be long remembered by all of us. A man who has joined our new neighbours, Monavie, Michael Ruane. We're thankful to him for coming back here today and show your appreciation. Come in, Michael. Timmy Ruane should have been here. Eugene Moore takes his place at full forward. Eugene. Kieran Devney. Now that has run out. Oh, Tom Cosgrove, your referee, and indeed the man who gave me ample coverage for years as fullback. Where are you hiding yourself at all? Oh, there he is now, into the centre of the arena. All the way from this stone banner. Give him a good round of applause there. Thank you, Tom. Peter Neal, is he anywhere there in the fringes? Peter. Oh, and don't be hiding yourself. Peter. He must be gone. We will get all of those fellows at a later juncture. We will now arrive at the presentation to Father Kenny. And the presentation will be made by Mrs. Paddy Nocton, the smile. This club saw fitting that on this the occasion of Father Kenny's Golden Jubilee that it would give him a token of our appreciation of his services to the people and indeed the club and to all in the parish over the years. Give him a good hand of applause now. As he said himself, he's the first priest that celebrated 50 years his Golden Jubilee with us. And he is right here among us now. Would you care to say a couple of words, Father? I know you're not short of the talk.
I appreciate it very much. You know, I'll hardly be around when the next 50 years comes. You'd never know. It's hard to kill a bad thing, you know. You'll have to step on me and put me down 6 feet. And when I'm down 6 foot, there won't be much hope. All of us are giving me. Oh, this is too much.
Well, now you're entitled to every bit of it if you take your cue in front of the car there. Mrs. Paddy Nocton, the smile, will make the formal presentation to our PP, Reverend Charles Kenny. And if you would, you could face this way and we'll get you on the video. You can be looking at yourselves for many a long year. Thanks very much now. Oh, indeed you can. You can use them right to the finish. All the way. That's lovely now. Thanks very much indeed. Thank you, Mary and Father. The progress and gather the goals for the 1936 and indeed for many a year with that. Give him a warm hand of applause there now. See, you're not getting tired clapping yet, are you? Right there. I don't know the order in which they played now. But on the fringe of the crowd there, John Paul Carey. Make your way in here, John. Mr. Men. John Paul Carey, father of a man who was with us there, Michael Carey. Mon McElwain. Bad man. Sonny Nocton, all the way from Vermont, father of Brian Nocton. Where did you take it after that? Tommy Quirk. He cannot hide himself anyway. Give him a big hand there. Paddy Murray. Pona Brown. Is he gone out? Oh, we're sorry about that now. Paddy, it appears, has left the pitch. Frank Dolan, our near neighbour. Good man, Frank. Jack Kelly. Have we Jack here with us? Peter Kelly. Peter was around earlier. I don't see him at the moment now. Mike O'Neill. If you keep shouting the names to me there, and I'll read them out. Jack Mitchell. Come on, let's not be shy. Is he hearing the audience at all? He must be gone also. Oh, have you presented Jim Hick? You was today. Could you reverse back a small bit, Jimmy? Jimmy, could you reverse back about 3 or 4 feet? That's lovely now, it's okay, that's grand now. Being taken round there by his son-in-law, Jimmy Mitchell, and his good wife sitting in the back seat there. We congratulate you, Jim, and wish you many a long day with us. We also have a medal here for brother Bestrant, and we would ask Sonny Nocton to take it for him. Could come forward here, Sonny, you'd take a medal for brother Bestrant. That medal is for brother Bestrant, and his brother there, Sonny Nocton, is taking it for him. As I said earlier, we will sort out the tail ends of the medal presentation at a function yet to be arranged, but it will be arranged very shortly. You see now, John Joe Crawwell, you see here present. And Father Tom Fling, sir. Any others that we have omitted, you might kindly remind us here and we'll call out their names. If there are, we would hate to make an omission. Paul Quinn, this mile. Paddy Glynn, Gralia. Paddy Glynn here, Gralia. That's lovely now. I hope we have covered everybody. And those of you who are leaving, let you make your way into the hall and you'll have tea and sandwiches and a little chess, and we'll wind off the evening on a lighter note. Thank all of you for coming. Now that'll be all right. We'll arrange that at a later stage. We'll let you all go away now and